Sometimes they be on point.
No, no, the
comments will bring awareness to shit like, you wasn't
even noticing. I'm projecting that?
Yeah.
That nigga look like he been hungry. Like, I'm hungry.
Why that nigga left eye twitch so much?
You understand me?
Like, damn, y'all niggas.
Hey, man, we live in action. Yo, I'm talking about it's the Cali Kickback.
Why that nigga lips chat?
Yo, I'm talking about
God.
Louis Belt, Teddy Ray. And we got motherfucking Craig Smith in the motherfucking building.
Craig Smith!
God!
Roast me king.
Get it from God.
Hey.
You know?
If I owe you, nigga, don't get it from me. Get it from God.
If I owe you something, you can get it from God, nigga.
What made you say that? Like,
a bitch. A dog head funky bitch. Shout out to the pimp homie Silky. A dog head dad. A stomp down, toe back, alien head bitch. No, I'm fucking with
you. I just pictured the predator right now. I was just wanting something.
Man, you know what was going on was, you ever deal with somebody that ain't really completely living in reality? And they expect,
I deal with niggas like that all day.
Right, so what was going on with the woman was, I was doing everything I could to make her feel great about herself.
Mm-hmm.
And nothing was working.
Was you like nice guy in there? Like, I'll buy your clothes.
Okay, I've been that nigga when I was like 19, 20. A bitch gave me a Christmas list with like 29 things. I got 27.
I can't make the most. And it felt bad.
It wasn't no pimping in me, man. Hey, man.
Damn. Oh, that's hella funny.
Straight up, man.
You had chicken like that? Or you spit your last on that ass.
Oh, man. You know I had chicken, man.
She knew it. She was like, ooh, I want everything.
Yeah, man. You know, I did that, man. I was a fool
nigga,
for
all
love.
That sharper image.
Yeah, man. And so it was something similar. Okay, so I learned from the gift buying thing early.
Mm-hmm.
But it was the equivocal to it, just in emotionality. You know, when you deal with a chick and you allow her to base y'all relationship mood and emotion on how she feel, you're going to always put yourself in the position where you got to tell the bitch to get it from God.
Mm-hmm.
So me and this bitch arguing. You ever been on one with a bitch for a few days? Like, when she call, you look at the phone and you're like, you know what I'm saying? So we just kept back and forth with the bullshit for like a week.
Only reason you picked up is because it's a mail over there. You
right.
Damn.
So now I'm on the phone. We
like
capping.
My check just landed, bitch. I know it's over there. I'm mad at you, though.
Hell yeah.
I ain't never let a check touch no other house.
A check?
A check?
I was couch surfing for a minute. I had mail going to hella other places.
That's common. Don't let these people make it like they don't be doing that.
I was couch surfing for God is good. And I only surf God. My own couch.
You ain't never been a sucker for a broad, Lou?
Mm-mm.
Wow.
I'm not lying. I'm not trying to come off that way. But I think I'm so, I love hard. So I've been stingy with my love. You know what I'm talking about? I ain't been trying to open up to a bitch. Right. You know what I'm saying? Because of, I don't know, probably fear, you know?
Yeah,
it's like motherfuckers that's been heartbroken and shit be open because they'd have been heartbroken. It's kind of like,
That's
you know? Cool. It's like a motherfucker be like, you ever been shot? Like, nah, I ain't been shot. I ain't trying to get shot. I ain't got no interest in it.
Yeah, you know what's cold about?
Yeah, it's like, you ever been heartbroken? Like, nah, shot. I'm not trying to.
Man, it's never happened.
Nuh-uh.
So you have?
What, trick?
Been heartbroken.
Heartbroken?
Yeah, Bible.
I've been let down. A bitch ain't never took my whole day away from me like on some emotion.
What's
awesome.
The difference from heartbroken and let down?
Because
I ain't been disappointed in a few bitches.
Okay, let me ask you a question.
That's what I'm saying. Let down. Like,
you ever been messing with
her? I thought she was going to ride harder.
And when y'all stop, you miss her and you feel it in your chest?
No.
Like where you could physically feel it like, God damn, this motherfucker, she's still inside my heart.
I feel you, because that's what all the R&B songs be talking about, and I be feeling that shit like I've been through something.
Man,
but
this nigga Christopher
it.
Williams, for real, nigga.
Man,
they be honest. I know it's going to happen to me eventually, so I'm not finna speak on it like, not it's going to guarantee happen, but nigga, you ain't nobody above from getting their heart broke, nigga. That's why I be protecting my shit. Yeah. Bitch, you ain't finna break my heart, bitch. You break my shit, it's over. Bitch, you break my heart. I'm a demon for life, man.
So y'all never told a woman that she was fucking that you love her?
Yes.
Yeah.
And you meant it?
I thought I did. And when I said it, I felt it, nigga. But then looking back on it, I was like, I shouldn't have said that shit. Or Damn. We'll be in a different space right now. You know, like, when I say I love you, nigga, I want that shit to be to my wife.
But
nigga,
you gotta understand, you older than us, too, though. Yeah. So the mother of my kids. Almost, I just turned 28 type shit.
And talk about how we niggas used to really write love letters back in the day.
Well, yeah.
It took a little bit of a time to, like...
It took effort, nigga. I
knock a bitch back in the day.
I remember you used to have to write a bitch's phone number on a piece of paper.
Yes.
You used to have to find a pen, find a piece of paper. Sometimes you couldn't find either one, and you had to memorize it. You know what I'm saying? And I had 10 numbers off memory.
You know what I'm saying? What you was focused on in your early 20s? Because I remember one day you see me, you was like, Lou, I'm proud of you. I like how you move. I wish I was thinking how you was thinking when I was your age. And I'm like, what the fuck? I'm like, I appreciate it, but shit. What you was doing, nigga?
Man, I was trying to get rich. The best way I could, you know what I'm saying? I was taking...
Nigga, I've been trying to get rich since I was a kid.
Yeah, but you can't mistake activity for progress, and that's what I was doing. I was doing hella shit that was making bread, but it wasn't really progressing me in life. It was just filling a materialistic void, you feel what I'm saying? Comedy, I always been funny. If I would have been hustling right younger, I would be way further right now. So that's what I mean by I was focused like y'all when I was y'all age, you know?
That's what I be thinking about, like that's Eddie Murphy game. And shit. When niggas still started at like 14.
Man.
Like I'd have started thinking about comedy when I was in high school, like.
Man. Nah, I'm glad. I feel like I'm glad I wasn't a comedian in high school. I think if I wasn't a comedian, if I was like on some chasing a dream in high school and shit, I'd have fucked up this comedian shit.
For real?
I did all my bad shit. I think that's why another reason why I ain't been like really like on some lovey-dovey shit. I've been loving comedy since I was 18. Like once I found something to do.
Yeah.
I ran with it type shit.
You know what's crazy? I wish I
my bad shit out the window.
Man, I wish I was like you. Because look, when I was 12, I met Jamie Foxx.
Damn, that's wrong.
I was in this.
You said that like that nigga was LA on the verge of
shit. No, I spent the whole day with this dude.
What? Damn, that's right. Yeah. R. Kelly Joe ass?
No. Shout out to Jamie. I ain't seen him since. But, no, I'm sorry.
I spent the whole day with Jamie when I was 12. Well, nigga, how'd that happen?
So I was in this program, program at the church, and the leader, the youth pastor, his best friend was a writer on A Living Color.
Damn.
And I was, nigga, I was like bad. So they was like, if you get your grades up, you know what I'm saying, I'm going to have my boy take you up to A Living Color and introduce you to the cast.
Wow.
And at the time, A Living Color was like the most, you know what I mean? So I got my grades up from D's and C's to A's and B's. Damn. So he really took me up there. Me and my boy Dion, and when we got there in the morning. My boy Dion went with David Allen Greer and basically shadowed him for a whole 8 hours, and I was with Jamie Foxx.
Wow.
Yeah, we was just bagging on each other and cracking jokes. Like, we had a good time. He was a good dude.
Damn, that's raw.
I should have been on it then. Like, oh, I could be a comedian, but I never thought... You know, I never thought that was something that you could actually do.
But, you know, shit like that happens for a reason. Like, you needed that story. You needed that motivation. Like, everything... You needed to do what you did after, you know.
Right, right.
All of that money chasing. Everything happened for a reason to make you where you at today.
For sure.
Straight up.
You know, so don't look at it like, oh, I should have, you know. Even though we should, I mean, we do be looking at life like, oh, man, if I would have did this earlier, if I would have been on that, ooh, I wish I would have been on Bitcoin when it first type shit, you know, like.
That's real shit.
We always, you know, want to be somewhere where we
are. Living in Southern California, how did you feel like being a comedian wasn't a thought, because there's so many successful comedians out here, and you didn't met like you said, you didn't seen Jamie Foxx and shit like that. It's kind of like you didn't think like shit, I could be a comedian.
You know what I think for me, because I didn't know any comedians.
Oh, okay.
You know, I knew regular type people, truck drivers.
Yeah,
motherfucking with a bachelor's degree. But I never met nobody that did comedy. Like growing up, I never remember somebody like, come on, we going to Daryl's stand-up show.
Yeah.
I don't remember that. I remember going, you know, hooping and, you know, regular everyday
nigga
shit.
Yeah.
So, so I guess it was just my environment, nigga. I know a hella niggas that was trying to be rappers.
Yeah.
But comedy wasn't even, I was embarrassed to tell my family.
You was too.
When I started. You were, too. Yeah, I was embarrassed.
I didn't tell my mom or dad.
I lied. Had to find out. I told niggas I was going to the store when I went to my open mic.
You said you went to, I'm
going to the store right quick. I'll be back.
What? Why you feel like we felt that way at the time?
nigga, who want to open their wings up and they don't work, nigga, in front of people? You be like, right. Nigga, I finally got my wings, nigga. I'm finna fly, nigga. Right. Shit. Hold on, nigga. I just hit the tree. Yeah, I just hit the top of this car. So some niggas fly on that first time. Some niggas hit the top of the car. I hit the top of the car.
Yeah.
I did both. I hit the top of the car and flew into the motherfucker.
Really? How was over. Your first performance?
I murdered. I just bagged on people. I always been a super bagger. I just bagged in my second show. I bombed.
Oh, wow. Really?
Yeah, my second show I bombed.
My shit was the reverse. My first show I bombed. My second show I did way better. Me too.
My first show was ass. Second show I went dumb.
Yeah.
On my mama.
Yeah, to man.
Damn. So what did? So how did you bomb the second time? You trying to tell a set?
You know what? I didn't even know about a set. I just went up there with no jokes. I thought I was going to be able to come up to the top.
And just be that nigga?
Because that's what I did the first time. You know what I mean?
So how did it go when you walked those stage?
Man, I just remember it was...
Where was you at?
I was in Corona. In AD. You know AD?
Yeah.
He had a room at like a golf course.
Oh, no.
It was all white people. I murder white crowds most of the time. But early, I had no idea. And I just started bagging.
And you can't, white people don't react well to bagging.
No.
Damn.
It's weird. Just, like, you can't just be, look at this old spotted brown white bitch in the front.
I was fearful
like,
of white people when I started.
Really?
But I ain't never... was in a crowd of white people and made they ass laugh. I was hanging around niggas. So it's like
started Oakland niggas.
So I'm like, boy. Like I never white I was fearful of white people for a long time, bro. But my mama on some performing because I'm like, they not gonna understand what I'm saying. I tell jokes like try to be like relatable. Yeah. I don't tell like made up shit. I tell shit like, boy, don't you hate when, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, so I'm like, how the fuck they gonna feel me? So I was fearful for sure. So you wasn't fearful, you had confidence.
Yeah, I was an athlete. And then, you know, because I was a good athlete growing up, I always went to the schools that was more diverse, that had the better teams, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, I was in high school with white folks and stuff like that, you know what I mean? Even though growing up, where I grew up, it wasn't a lot, but, you know, I always, that was easy. My thing was old black women.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Because my mom. And I don't cuss in front of my mom or say crazy shit in front of my mom. So
you see him and you get psyched.
I'm like, that's Donna right there, nigga. Yeah. I can't. That's Donna. I can't talk about pussy in front of Donna.
I'd have been like, I didn't see the crowd.
I used to go right in front of the crowd. Old black people, dick pussy. And I whipped out my dick. Ooh, ooh. And they be laughing. But I had a bad thing. I had to slow down. I used to call the crowd old. So I thought I was 18. So it's like I get on stage, I be like, they y'all old as a motherfucker.
Niggas in that bitch 38. Yeah. Like, hold on, like,
they was not fucking with that shit.
Oh,
I had to learn to use different terminology. You know what I'm saying? It's more mature crowd in this motherfucker. Shit like that.
Grown as
grown. Yeah. Shit like I used to be like, y'all hella old in this motherfucker.
It's just something for the lovers.
Something for the lovers.
Who grew up in the 80s? You gotta do shit like that.
That's some funny ass shit.
Who grew up in the 80s?
Where my 90s babies at?
Oh yeah, that's good.
So when you bombed, what'd you do? You got on stage hella fast?
No, I stayed up there and took it. I took it, yeah. And then that ride home was, I was questioning myself. You know,
that's a long ride from Corona.
Yeah, man. And then the next week, I was back at it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But I was working. I had a little trucking company and stuff. So my first 7-8 years of comedy, I didn't really progress a lot because I was working 60, 70 hours on a job. And then at night, going to the clubs.
Damn. Yeah, I used to think this nigga Kraig was coming to tow shit every time he pulled up.
Yeah. I try to get that nigga to hustle. That nigga called me. He said, "Look, I gotta get this money though." Yeah. I feel you, nigga. Shit.
Oh man, I'm ready now. But yeah, man. So my mentality was different. I think I lost a lot of opportunities because I didn't really pander and play the same type of games.
Really, you think so?
Yeah, as far as like, you know, I think you know. Maybe
you
I was
a nigga, and them games ain't for you.
Exactly.
God got a whole different set of shit for you.
So I don't think you would miss the opportunities. The opportunities wasn't made for you because if you was available or not, they ain't checking for no real niggas like that.
Right,
I was available, nigga.
Yeah, that nigga crazy.
We niggas the same shit.
Yeah. That's, but you know, I even had to check a few people on saying that about me.
What?
Because a lot of times people will say something like that around the wrong people. Mm-hmm. That look, that's what you call a dog whistle. Like, if I'm around a bunch of execs or, you know, niggas that really got power, and you say, this a real nigga right here. Mm-hmm. That's going to make, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I've had in front of execs with niggas.
Wow, really?
Yeah, I don't know what he talk about, man. I'm an everyday working man.
Yeah.
Well, my outlook is for everyday work. My brand is for people who pay taxes right. that are frustrated. Mm-hmm. And I say the things they wish they could say, but they'd lose their wife or their job.
Facts.
That's my brand of comedy. You know what I'm saying? I know my brand, and sometimes I got to tell people, because if people can get shit misconstrued and think
that's just an employed real nigga.
Yeah, but you got to remember, niggas will try to put stigmas on you so you don't get work.
Facts, yeah.
You feel what I'm saying?
He'll put stigmas on you.
So you don't get work. And Lewis, they'll say, oh, yeah, he's funny. He's you know, he's funny. Mm-hmm. He just,
like me with this weed. Uh-huh. I'd be like, oh, this nigga, Teddy, we love him, but he just pulls up and he be high.
Right.
Like, they gonna say that about everybody.
But he be high, though.
That was that, but he be high. You gotta.
When niggas, I did Comedy Central, they was like, if you please could just not smoke before you go on camera, because, like, the camera, we wanna see your eyes. And I said,
but they don't tell. Say, but they don't tell superstars that.
They don't tell other people who got tight eyes. Yeah. Nigga, that's what I'm saying. Shit. Like, what? Like,
somebody hated. Somebody said something.
I smoked the extra blunt, nigga, and did the set that's already up there. Like, the set that was up there. I had an injury that time, too. Like, y'all not finna tell me not to smoke, and I'm performing injured.
I think, I don't know, and then to your point, Kraig, I think I never try to be accepted.
Yeah.
So it's like, I think, and that come from probably my school trauma, my childhood trauma. Nigga, when I try to be good or try to be accepted in whatever the fuck organization, nigga, I always fail. So as an adult, I never tried to do some shit that didn't fit me.
Yeah.
You feel me? So if it's like, if you can't accept me for who I am, and I'm telling you, now I'm not going to show my hand, but at the end of the day, I'm not going to, you feel me, act like something I'm not.
But it's very important as you get older, right, to mm-hmm. know how to separate who you are mm-hmm. from what you do.
Mm-hmm.
You feel mm-hmm. what I'm saying? We make people laugh. We aren't, like, you aren't a comedian. You're just, you're a man that makes people laugh. Yeah. So what happens with people who may not be as intelligent uh-huh. is they try to put you into a corner, you into a certain thing,
mm-hmm.
and you got to dig your way out of it. You know, it's always important that, you know what I'm saying, you're able to take the gloves off and box bare knuckle or put them back on or slap box. But don't just say, I'm only fighting one way, nigga, because whatever I got to do,
uh-huh.
I'm prepared to do that.
On mamas.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Today, I do MMA.
Why not, Joe?
Yeah.
Why not, Joe?
Yeah. I always, you know, try to go for a businessman first, you know, because at the end of the day, the motherfuckers that make the most money haven't been the niggas that told the joke.
It's straight up and down.
So it's kind of like, and them niggas don't go in there and they don't got no stigma on them.
Right.
Them niggas go in there, they stigma is they a businessman.
Mm-hmm.
So if I walk in that motherfucker as a businessman, nigga, it is what it is. And what I'm saying, you can fuck with her, you can't. But, you know, numbers lie. People,
you know,
don't.
A quote changed my shit.
People lie, numbers don't. So.
I agree.
And like, that's why the funniest nigga in the room usually is the brokest.
Facts.
So I was like, that shit fucked me up. I almost couldn't write a joke after that because I was so broke. I was like, let me figure out life first, nigga, before I just...
That's the benefit of starting later. That is the benefit of starting later, is you know who you are. Is it like a man or a woman?
Uh-huh.
Like, when like y'all at the age now where y'all realize everybody full of shit.
Yeah.
I used to think...
I just figured this shit out about a week ago.
You can't put nobody on the table, including your mama, who ain't been full of shit at some time.
Mm-hmm.
So when you accept that and you stop looking for people to be great and you just look at them, looking for them to be who they are, it makes shit easier and you know how to move better. You know what I'm saying? Because you can call, now you comfortable calling a nigga on shit that's bullshit.
Mm-hmm.
But most motherfuckers, when they're young, what they do is they don't want to fuck off the bigger opportunity, so they let bullshit fly and dance in bullshit without realizing that it's getting all over you.
That shit fucked my life up. That's
that shit getting in you and all over you. The more you're around bullshit, it's in you. Now when you ain't around it, you a bullshit nigga because that's what you've been dancing in. You smell like it, you feel like it, and you don't even realize
it. You don't even realize it.
You know what I'm saying? That's why I like the way you move and the way you move. I don't never see you tucking up under nobody's wing for stage time, or you either just doing shit that's not, it don't make you a hoe.
No, it make you, not, I'm not, I'm gonna let you go.
But you gotta have your own, bro. There's niggas out here I love, like, who I could probably be around if I wanted to, mm-hmm. who I'm fans of, but I'm not. I could be around Tony Baker if I want, he a good nigga, but that, I'm trying to make my own way.
Right.
You know, I could be around Big Jai all the time, that's my nigga. I love him, but I'm trying to make my own way. It ain't no disrespect, mm-hmm. but I, you know what I'm saying? I'm trying to get mine too, but you mm-hmm. can't really develop as an artist mm-hmm. if you are too self-conscious to be out here on your own failing.
Facts.
You feel what I'm saying? You want to ride another nigga coattail because you like, you know, bitches think like this. Bitches will be around a nigga with money and think they got money.
Yeah.
And be like, we straight.
Yeah. We good. No, yeah. Nigga, we ain't shit.
Come get us.
Yeah.
Us.
Yeah. And that balance for me was the Bay. Because I wasn't around comedians. Like, the first time I was ever, like, around comedians was when I got out here. They wasn't. I'm around rappers, pimps, and hustlers. I'm not.
Yeah, I was. So, I didn't go around comedians until I started hanging out comedy clubs.
Yeah. So it's like, it the niggas like, that was getting money wasn't comedians. Right. So my whole thing was, oh, I know the joke ain't the, I don't give a fuck about being the funniest. That right. never been, like, nobody in this industry can walk in any room I am and be like, well, Lewis ain't that funny to me. I wouldn't give a fuck.
Yeah.
I wouldn't give a fuck.
Because it don't exist. Ain't no funniest, nigga.
Yeah, it ain't. But it's a lot of people in this industry, though. That's what they focus is.
That shit crazy to me.
Yeah. But I understand it because
that used to be my focus. I ain't gonna hold you.
That's it's supposed I wanted to be, though.
Write the funniest joke ever.
Mm-hmm.
But that's different than trying to be the funniest. Look, the thing is this. It's 7 billion different people on this planet. And that means it's 7 billion different realities. Mm-hmm. So no matter how hard you try to be the funniest, if it's 100 niggas that love you, it's going to be 100 more that be like, I don't get it.
I don't understand.
Like, I remember mm-hmm. when I started blowing up off that roast me shit, niggas mm-hmm. would say, I don't get it.
Mm-hmm.
And they don't know I know what they mean by that. You mm-hmm. know what I'm saying? It's... Everybody has a different approach. Everything that I approach is psychological. Like, before I do anything, I analyze it psychologically and I try to figure out the psychology behind whatever it is I'm doing.
You know why they didn't get it, Craig? Because a lot of your jokes had... A lot of jokes are just set up punch, nigga. Your jokes had accessories to it, nigga. Like, your jokes had an awning, nigga, a side door, a pool, like, a back door. Like, you just took...
Yeah, yeah.
It was just more vivid. You feel me?
Yeah,
like you told some nigga he lost his front tooth in a corn dog bite. I pictured the bite.
That's funny, man.
Yeah.
I pictured the bite, nigga. Yeah. You know, this nigga told me I built like a meat avalanche. I see the avalanche,
bruh. People still talk about the joke you told me. It was some shit about an ostrich. Oh, some shit, bro. Nigga, bro, they like, bro, that's the only joke I hear. Like, motherfucker just be like, call me that. Motherfucker, I hardly just get roasted. You know, motherfucker say some weak shit about me. Oh, yeah. You're old, pretty boy, corny shit. You know, I'm like, this nigga hit me with a good joke. I'm like, I can't fuck with this nigga, bro.
Shout out to Teddy for bringing me on this show.
Shout out Teddy to Teddy for creating the show.
Teddy created it, and he reached out and brought me on it. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Teddy is a legendary nigga, man.
Yeah, for
He's
sure.
He's a legendary nigga, man. And both of y'all going to go down as some of the greatest to ever do this shit. You know what I'm saying?
I appreciate that, man. So, you know. A lot coming from you.
Man.
Yeah, straight up, man.
I just really wanted to see niggas win, bro.
Yeah. Teddy,
you know what that roast me moment was for? When they told me I could do. That's why I'm not mad at the show. I'm not. I was never was like, oh, whatever, whatever. Because niggas really won.
Yeah.
And that's what I wanted.
Yeah.
You put the whole class on.
Yeah. I was like, niggas really won. Fuck who got the credit. Yeah. Fuck whatever, whatever. Mm-hmm. I don't care about that shit at the end of the day. Mm-hmm. Niggas really won. This man could work, put his family on. This nigga take 9 niggas on tour.
Oh, mama.
Like eat a earth, wind, and fire, nigga.
Like, mama, I appreciate
you, man.
Happy for niggas, bro.
Hey, like, you put
utterly.
Teddy put half of our class on, man.
Damn.
With that roast me shit.
Yeah, that all Def Digital shit was big.
You know what I mean?
See, that was like that all Def Digital, all that shit. That was so like a part of the part of my process of coming out here because I'm like, oh shit, Russell Simmons. Feel me? That's like the modern day Def Jam.
It is.
So I'm like, all right, boom. I get out there and do that. Nigga, I never was accepted. Only motherfucker that fucked with me on that shit was Teddy and Doughboy. Really Doughboy too, because yeah. Doughboy really was more
big familiar. Shout out to Doughboy.
Doughboy, love sure. you, man.
On my mama, he the one because he was. For me, because he from up north. He from Sacramento. Yeah. So he already knew my movements. So he like, nigga, he was throwing me little plays yeah, and shit. But yeah. I was like, I never could have been part of that shit because I'm like, shit, it's only like two niggas. I love everybody.
Yeah. I definitely felt like the odd man out because I wasn't in none of them cliques up there. And the people had to choose me.
Yeah.
Because when
yeah,
I came yeah. up there, they thought
but
I was...
That's, but don't it feel better when man. The people choose you?
Facts.
And I'm that's all I be like, man, fuck what. I don't care who choose me, nigga.
No, the people.
I got God.
Yeah.
I got my family.
Facts.
I'm good.
And the people. And then what I love is how they respond to us on the street.
Yeah.
When you making people laugh, it don't be no dangerous energy, bro. Yeah. I done had niggas move their pistol to the side like, this cuz right here. Yep. Cuz, can I get a picture, cuz? Yep. And that shit make me feel good because I want to see unity. I want to see unity in our communities more than anything. And that's the plus to laughter. It's like, man, I could make these niggas.
I do feel like we got the most thuggish of the fans.
Oh, most sure. definitely.
Like,
I'm telling you, nigga,
like the most
for the
thuggish,
West Coast,
like,
the most hood, I know for sure, me, Teddy, Wasomi Kwan, yourself, Slink Johnson.
Yeah, Slink got
shout
the
out to Slink.
The big homie.
I would say them five got the most gangsters fan base.
I like how this nigga introduced me.
Street niggas that love.
Yeah, they love us. They do. They love us.
I'm telling, like you said, yeah. when niggas moving straps in, yeah, niggas yeah. be ready to drop tears when they yeah. see me. I'm so bro, my mama, nigga, I be fighting hella demons, nigga, when I see you, nigga. I be watching your videos, nigga. And on my mama, nigga, you the only nigga.
You know how niggas be really bending. And I be appreciating that shit, though. You feel me? I be like, nigga. I be like, that shit make me feel good, bro, because I know how. I got motherfuckers that fuck with me that don't fuck with comedians. I don't fuck with comedians, but nigga, I fuck with what you got going on.
I care.
And
bro,
they okay, be like they give me a list. I don't fuck with niggas. I fuck with Kraig.
Yeah.
Me too.
I fuck with
yeah. I fuck with Teddy. You got to bring the hood hell of me. Bring the fat nigga from L.A. Teddy. That nigga, you feel me? That nigga that be roasting niggas.
And Kraig. You know the ultimate legend that everybody love. Boo Capone.
Boo Capone.
Shout out to Boo.
Boo Capone is a legend.
He is, bro.
They love that nigga. Yeah. Everywhere, man.
Yeah, for real. But that's just some West Coast shit too, though. We got that.
Boo give you that element, like, and I'm not even trying to be funny, but it's always that wild nigga in the hood that don't shut the fuck up.
That's Boo.
Yeah,
that's Boo.
Just a crazy.
Every
nigga,
every ghetto got a nigga that or a nigga that can't stop talking.
Yeah, in his eyes.
You want him to shut up, but you kind of don't, because it's like
because he's funny. It's like a drunk ass uncle.
Hey, me and Boo bombed at a roast.
Oh, I was never gonna bring this up ever in life.
No, what? Man. Teddy did his thing, man. We roasted. Anderson Pak and what was it?
Manny Dumbfounded.
Pac. No, the other nigga looked like Manny Pacquiao. Mom.
Was it Dumbfounded?
No, the nigga that is on tour with Anderson Pak, Bruno Mars.
Oh,
he looked like Jenny Pacquiao. we roasted them in Boo Capone. I got up there just I could see it wasn't gonna happen for me. So I bowed out after two or three jokes. Boo Capone bombed for 25 minutes.
Damn.
And when I tell you it was the most incredible bomb I've ever seen.
Damn, and he really was like, and you know how a nigga, like ODB or something, like a nigga that really think he's saucing it in his mind? Mm-hmm. And then on my final joke. Like
20 minutes in, bro, we got Willow Smith in there. It's like real Hollywood in there. You know what I mean? And he went up and just talked about Boo for 10 minutes and murdered.
Yeah. I did like three jokes on Anderson, and then I was like, but Boo, what the fuck was you talking about? Nigga, like, Boo made it easy for me. Like, yeah. Really.
Ooh, that was fun. Shout out to Anderson Pak, man.
Damn.
I tell you what, man, I think I know greatness when I see it, right? Mm-hmm. And to watch him perform on his birthday, bro, is one of the most amazing things I've ever seen. This nigga is the lead drummer and the lead vocalist in his band, and he don't miss a beat, bro. It's like
not one.
It's incredible.
Not one. Shout out to the bro Anderson. I was just with him the other night shooting a music video. That nigga don't. He the hardest working nigga. He James Brown mixed with Nate Dogg.
That's
a hell of a combination,
bro. I'm telling you, if anybody's the next Michael Jackson,
damn,
he got that type of
with,
juice
with some mic in him too. A little bit.
He got that type of juice.
I ain't seen a moonwalk yet. I gotta see how
he can't
slide.
Be Mike without the moonwalk.
Man,
moonwalking at it. That nigga.
But as far as his stage performance, bro.
Stage presence.
Second to none. I've been to a few of his concerts. Yeah, me. I remember seeing that nigga. I was out of town. I had a show in Maine. And he had a show that night in Boston. And I just slid to that nigga shit after my shit. And just watched his shit. I was just in awe. Like, watching it from the crowd. Like, how he just hop up, rap, sing, hop on the drums, nigga. And then, like, he just rotate that shit. Like,
yeah.
It's like watching Magic Johnson play every position, it's, nigga. It's like,
God, beyond damn. Incredible.
I need to see it.
I keep sliding down. Beyond incredible.
But yeah, long story short, this nigga Boo didn't know who was there. He didn't give a fuck. He just bombed.
Bro, it was hella, like, just powerful. It was one of them, like, it was one of them audiences where, like, you know, it was more rich people than regular people, I would say.
Hell yeah.
You know what I mean?
That's not fun.
No, not at all. He was throwing haymakers, though.
That's crazy.
Oh, crazy. Tomorrow.
But Boo would get you on some shit and be like, all right, now that was funny.
No, he going to do some dope stuff. Yeah,
nah, that was funny.
Yeah, he been calling crazy. Me a red lobster cheddar biscuit for the last month and a half.
Red lobster cheddar biscuit. Bro, that nigga had me rolling one time. I seen that nigga before. It was somewhere. I forgot where the fuck it was at. But that nigga, this nigga talk, he tell his story. It was just hella funny because I was new to being L.A. type shit. And that nigga's like, nigga, I was on Florence, nigga, flaming, nigga. Nigga all red, flaming. Yeah. Nigga, I'm like, this nigga telling a joke. He got the crowd laughing. I'm like, bro, this nigga crazy, bro.
Yeah.
I'm like, bro, he got that type of presence. You meet that nigga once, you'll never forget him.
Never.
You know what I'm saying?
And if you meeting that nigga, you probably, I don't know, bro, my first... Three times I seen that nigga, he was getting kicked out of somewhere.
Yeah, he wanted those.
Like, back in the day, it used to be bad. Like, Boo was getting kicked out. Now Boo can kick it. I don't know. You know, his energy got better. Mm-hmm. And shit, now he understand, like, nigga, you was doing the most back then, nigga. That nigga was getting kicked out, nigga. Like, the comedy club, every...
Comedy is a very square-ass industry.
I agree.
Ran by nerds.
Ran by nerds.
I think it's only like 10 hood comedians out of this whole industry.
I'm a relationship specialist, huh?
Yeah, I'm not even a hood comic, bro.
I'm not even gonna say hood, but I'm saying, when I say hood, I mean nigga.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, if I'm talking rap, nigga, is, you know, Lil Baby is a nigga. Yeah. What's right, her name? Right. Whoever the fuck. I don't even know.
Russ.
Russ Lil is Baby not a nigga. Russ. Yeah. It's like fucking, what's her name? Bro from Chicago. You got G Herbo, and then you got the other nigga, Chance the Rapper.
Right.
It's like they all black men, but yeah, it's the difference between being black and being a nigga.
You know what it is?
It's like 10 niggas in comedy, and then everybody
Chance
else.
Chance might give you some nigga moments, though.
No, everybody got a nigga moment.
That nigga was, he had some gangsters with him. I was like, some praying gangsters.
Yeah.
Well, I mean by nigga, I mean, would you be cool in high school? No. It's about 10 niggas that probably was cool in high school.
Right.
I wasn't cool in high school like that, nigga. Niggas knew me, but I wasn't cool.
What do you consider cool? Because you could be a cool, chubby nigga that's hella funny, that be chill with the weed and be fucking with your little hoes every blue moon, and then you a player-ass nigga.
Right.
Cool don't mean you talking a lot. Cool mean, nigga, you can go and slide and... Nigga, me and you could have went to a party and fucked around the whole shit.
Right, okay.
Nigga, if we lived on the same block, we would have went to the party, nigga. Then we would, you know what I'm saying, fucked around, they would have made it back. Nigga, if niggas want to chunk them, we would have chunked them. We would fuck with some hoes, we would have fucked with some hoes.
Right. Being able to be around. Okay, I guess I was in social circles and shit, yeah.
Was you outside?
Yeah. Okay, yes.
Alright, you just pulled off a miracle when you got grown, because nigga, this nigga be outside as a dope.
Now, comedy is definitely full of socially awkward weirdos. And they really like only fucking with niggas that they ain't intimidated by.
Why is that?
I think, I don't know if they equate masculinity with fear. I don't know what it is. But I find myself sometimes having to suck my chest in a little bit. because my natural disposition may seem like I'm tripping, but I'm not even tripping. I'm right. I'm a nerdy nigga. I read. I like weird facts and shit. I'm not.
But no your chill shit be looking so like.
Yeah, I'm.
I don't fuck with niggas. It be like, nah, I'm chilling.
It just don't be that. I don't know, man. It's weird in that way, and I don't know why it's like that. I think what's happening now, starting with our generation, mm-hmm. and it started a little bit before. Mm-hmm. When you get sprinkles of real niggas like a Mike Epps who mm-hmm. got to that superstar level, mm-hmm. and you know my boy from the Bay, what's his name, Mr. Cooper,
Mark Curry,
who, mm-hmm. you know, he's just like real black men, mm-hmm. but they don't necessarily seem like system niggas. You know what I'm saying? Like mm-hmm. they seem like Mike Epps, Corey Holcomb. These are niggas. When I first what made me want to do comedy is seeing Mike Epps and Scruncho at the Ontario Improv in 2007.
Swear.
Because I had never, even though I met Jamie Foxx when I was a kid, I wasn't a man yet.
Right. Mm-hmm.
But I had never met somebody who did comedy where I was like, oh, that reminds me of me, or that's somebody mm-hmm. I would have hung with. Mm-hmm. It was always like, you know what I mean, real nerdy, real skinny or whatever, big or whatever. You feel what I'm saying? But it wasn't no normal, everyday looking niggas I felt mm-hmm. that was just regular motherfuckers.
That's what I mean by niggas.
Right. That's how I felt about Duval my first time seeing him.
Okay, yeah.
That. Uh-huh. Because his Twitter, if it wasn't for Duval's Twitter, I probably would have never tried to write a joke.
Really?
Damn.
Yeah. Because it was the way he was saying shit on Twitter every day that made me laugh. Uh-huh. I'm like, oh, this nigga's just basically writing jokes every day yep. in front of our faces.
Yeah.
Type shit. And I, you know, after a while, kind of that, I took that nigga formula as far as, that's how I tried to train myself on how to write jokes based off his Twitter. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, makes sense.
Damn, that's wild. Yeah, for me it was Mike Epps, Scruncho. Then when I started doing it, did this happen to y'all too? When you start doing comedy, you start realizing, oh, that nigga's a genius.
Yeah.
Well, but before you did it, it didn't. You know, like I didn't think Dave Chappelle was a genius before I started doing
me
comedy.
Me neither.
I didn't think Corey Holcomb was a genius before I started doing comedy. Or
it's a lot of genius motherfuckers, which makes me understand why niggas' mentals ain't right out right. here. Because genius and insanity is
I think pleasant, a lot of comedians nigga. Are genius, though.
We evaluate things on such a deeper level than the average person. The other day, I was watching National Geographic, and I saw a cat sit next to a riverbank cleaning itself. To a normal motherfucker, that's a cat sitting next to a river cleaning itself. Mm-hmm. But then it came to my mind, oh, wow. Two creatures could be doing the same exact thing, mm-hmm. but for different reasons, right? Mm-hmm. So if that was a deer cleaning itself by the riverbank, he would just be trying to get clean. He probably would jump in the water and get out, uh-huh. right? But for a cat, it's different. A cat, I believe, when a cat's trying to clean itself, it's trying to get the scent of whatever its last kill was on its body so it can get closer to whatever it is it's trying to hunt. Because if it was just trying to clean itself, it would have just jumped in the water. Uh-huh. You feel what I'm saying? Uh-huh. I don't know if you're following me.
I'm following you.
Okay. So two things doing the same thing could be doing the same thing for different reasons, but it depends on where they land on the food chain. Uh-huh. You feel what I'm saying? Uh-huh. You be getting niggas that go up to the Monday night mic the Monday night shit every Monday. Uh-huh. Some niggas is up there a little higher on the food chain, and they're there to perform.
Yeah.
Other niggas are there to knock a bitch.
Yeah.
Mm. Other niggas are there to hang out.
Exactly. Show a fit off.
We in the same place.
Yeah.
Doing the different same modes. Thing for different reasons.
Yeah.
A normal nigga ain't gonna think no shit like that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know, so you gotta realize where you are on the food chain.
Oh, my mama. Mm. That's a game,
nigga. That's where this game will change you, nigga. Because you be humble, you think you the shit, nigga. And you pull up in your new 320 Beamer. Oh, I'm the shit. And then here come Mike Epps in a motherfucking Bentley. Yeah. And then here comes somebody else in a motherfucking Lamborghini truck.
Yeah. And they will take your bitch.
And they will take your bitch.
Yeah,
you know, real spill.
And won't even be trying to. Just on some.
Matters what bitch you with. Matters what you told the bitch too, though. We ain't finna make it. You know what I'm saying?
Hey. This nigga Lou made it seem like they took his bitch.
I done had rich niggas hate on me, man. You understand me? You know what I'm talking about? Game you can't buy. You know what I'm talking about? You understand me? So, yeah. Matters what bitch you with, matters who, what nigga the bitch with, you know what I'm talking about? Matters what he talking about, what you smelling like, you know what I'm talking about? All type of shit, man.
Right.
Money. What do y'all feel about Michael Blackson? He just said some shit on the Shannon Sharp show. He said basically like on some...
When you got money, you can have a hella hoes?
Basically, yeah. When you got money, you... motherfuckers value your opinion, or when you look like money. He said he understand why people in LA and Hollywood, I'm not gonna say LA, in Hollywood, fake it till they make it. Cause say if you dress nice and you pull up in something raw, people will take your business more serious versus if you don't got it. How y'all feel about that?
I mean, I'm gonna tell you like this. Whatever you gotta do to get in the door,
mm-hmm.
that's just what you gotta do.
Wow.
For me, the only thing I ain't doing is gay shit.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? I go mm-hmm. buy a truck and get back on the road. Mm-hmm. But that's just me.
Yeah.
But I may have, you know what I mean?
I feel like you be like that all the time. Like, I get back on the truck.
I get back on the truck.
Like, he be this close to quitting all the time. Yeah. Fuck around. Yeah.
So
be on I-5.
Yeah.
Man. Bum, bum. Me.
But if you're faking it till you make it, you better have some real talent. Because you're going to get in the door. People going to give you a shot. But if you don't deliver it, that could be your own, you know what I mean? It could be over for you.
Mm.
So whatever it is you're trying to do, you just got to deliver. You know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh. I see what you're saying. No matter how you get in the dough, it's about you got to bet. So you think, of course, you got a better chance of getting the dough.
Bro, I done had showcases with holes in my shoes
mm-hmm.
and have won against niggas with brand new Versace shoes, nigga.
Straight up.
It's all about the nigga.
Yeah.
And who you are that night, nigga. Like, who you believe, like, what do you believe in? Like, you know, like, it's not about the fit. Now, I have learned, yes, business-wise,
mm-hmm.
nigga, dress it up, nigga.
Mm-hmm.
I was on some, nigga, I'm gonna wear holes in all my shoes. Like, I had that kind of spirit for a minute.
Mozzie shit.
Huh?
That's how Mozzie is.
Mozzie was mobbing until he made it, nigga.
For real?
Because it's a mental thing, because you don't want to get too, you don't want to make it seem like this is nice-ass watch and these shoes, and this the reason why they fucking with me.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. You know, I really want it to be like my comedy is why they fucking with me, not mm-hmm. the shit.
I was sleeping on my version of the shoes was sleeping on the floor.
Uh-huh.
I didn't sleep in the bed for like a couple of years. Mm. I got to be uncomfortable.
Facts.
Hey, low key.
You feel what I'm saying?
My comfortable was just being in LA.
Yeah, yeah.
Having it my way. Yeah. Where I'm from, I could be a motherfucker. The route I was going, I could just be a Bay legend, have my little Camaro SS and buy a chain and be the nigga. Or take it to the next level and try to really get rich.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So I was like, okay, sacrificing some money was the sacrifice for me. I could have been financially way more stable in my early stages if I would have just been doing all the local shit.
Right.
You know?
Right.
But I had to take it like, all right, nigga, let me move and sacrifice some cheese. So that was my sacrifice. And I'm like, man, that's hard.
Teddy, you think you would have ended up in LA if you was from somewhere else?
Hell yeah, you would have.
Low key, I don't know, bro. I was born out here, and I moved to Florida and came back. So, like, it's magnetic, nigga. Like,
yeah, I think I ended up here too, man.
Bro, hell yeah, bro. You gotta understand how I look. I'm from California, and I looked at LA like, nigga, like a movie. Nigga, because I ain't had no family. I ain't grow up coming out here and none of that shit. So, nigga, I came to L.A., nigga. That was like going to New York to me.
Right.
Nigga, I ain't been to New York, L.A., none of that shit. Yeah, niggas went on some Universal Studios type shit, on some little kid shit. But now I don't know, nigga. I'm bouncing out and knowing people and doing shit.
That's how we was at the Bay. We went to Fisherman's Wharf, nigga. We took that little boat trip around Alcatraz, nigga. And that was it, nigga.
Yeah.
We wasn't hopping out seeing Frisco like that.
You see what I'm saying? And I don't think I done that shit you saying you did in the Bay. Verse
you
like
did. We, me and your mama talked about
it. Oh, we talked. So I was baby. Because
you. Because I forgot how she got to describe it to you. You be like, oh, yeah, that shit.
Yeah.
Because if I say the name, you don't know what the fuck it is. Yeah.
My parents was doing all the dope shit when I couldn't remember.
Exactly.
Disneyland trips and White House, all that. I'm 16 months. I'm seeing pictures. Yeah, I'm seeing pictures. Like, man, this is Washington D.C. We went to.
Yeah. Why can't we go down? Shit.
I remember my parents taking me out of state. Like, we went to Atlanta. And then, shit, family house with Texarkana and shit like that. And that ain't crazy.
Right, but, man.
Yeah, shit.
But you gotta see
I went to the Bahamas as a kid. We went on the cruise. We went to Miami. And then we got on the boat on the cruise. And we went to the Bahamas. That shit was wrong.
That's big.
Yeah. So I don't remember. I remember my little baby local shit. But I don't remember going to motherfucking San Francisco, getting on water. I don't remember that shit.
Man, that's
big. I don't recall that shit.
Bahamas is big.
You ever see niggas that be like, they never left the hood? Like, they never left.
Oh, yeah.
And you be like, damn, like, you feel like that shit matter? Like, bro, traveling as a kid?
Bro, that shit matter a lot, bro. That shit.
Because, like, bro, I want my kids to see shit. I used to come back. I would be scared to tell homies about going to the museum on the weekends. Like, you do shit with your family?
That's hilarious.
Damn. Oh, you went to go learn with your mama this weekend, hey, nigga?
Damn.
This is a mark, homie.
Yeah. That traveling at an early age really matter.
I think so, man. Environment is everything, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You ever get a prostitute off the track, man? You get her at the gym, she feel like a regular everyday specimen.
Yeah.
That's why you got to keep them in the field. You know what I'm saying? Because they start morphing into their environment.
Yeah.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. And that's why you got a lot of nerds around cool shit. Now they think they cool. Like what you was talking about. You're around something cool. You're a fucking nerd.
Look at the people that certain people put on. I ain't going to say no names.
Uh-huh.
But go in the East Circle of established comedians and then look at what's around them and that'll fuck you up. You feel what I'm saying?
You think somebody could put somebody on?
I don't think somebody could put somebody.
No.
Oh, well, hold on. It depends. Eddie Murphy put on Chris Rock. Eddie Murphy put on a lot of dudes. So if really? At a certain stage, yeah. You know, certain people can get you a deal, bro. Certain people can make a call and get you a deal.
Okay.
Gerard Carmichael could get you a deal.
Okay, right. You're right. Niggas can put you on. Niggas can't get you hot.
No.
That's what a nigga can't do. I can give you opportunity on opportunity on opportunity on opportunity. I can't make these people fuck with you.
The people.
Yeah. That's what's getting hot, nigga. Like, the people now, you know. Like how Thug was like, okay, this my nigga Gunna. And we like, oh, no, I fucks with Gunna now.
Yeah.
Like, but all the other niggas Thug was trying to get hot, and I can't get you niggas hot.
Yeah.
All y'all gonna be on slime, you know. Y'all gonna all.
Yeah, you're right.
That's a good point. Yeah. Cause I've been having this mixed feeling about putting on. It's hard. I don't think somebody could put you on, but I feel what you saying.
Yeah.
Cause motherfucker could put you on for sure.
I mean, you know, you can give a person a shot. Like you gave me that spot at the Improv a couple months ago, and from that some other stuff came.
But that's just how business work, I believe, right?
Yeah, but I feel you. But sometimes it takes somebody that's on the same vibe as you to recognize something in you.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Especially when it's different. Like, I feel like we all bring something different to the table. So, like, you understand that difference in me and vice versa.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But if it's another style, like if Ryan Davis was hosting Mondays at Improv, I probably would have never performed there. Not because nothing wrong with Ryan Davis.
Uh-huh. I know what you're talking about.
Different type of guy than him.
Uh-huh.
He's not going to be able to see that there are people funnier than him
mm-hmm.
that are way. You understand what I'm saying? And I'm not. I'm just using him as an example because we're different. But I can say that. You know what I'm saying? Or if a Kev on stage was the host there every Monday, I would never get it because I'm just too.
I see what you said.
You know what I mean? But D-Ray and you, I got action.
That goes back to niggas.
Right. Right.
We all black men.
That's what we are first.
We all black men first. But, nigga.
Black man.
We black men, right? But, nigga, right after that. Boom! Right after that, nigga.
Right.
And this nigga's black man. Then that white man after that. Then they some other shit after that. Then niggas some whole other shit after that. I'm not saying these men as an individual we were just currently talking about, but I'm just saying people in general. After the skin tone, what are you after that?
Right. You right. For me, you're a man before anything.
Facts.
Or if you're a woman, you're a woman before anything.
Because you see it out your own eyes. I can't be like, I'm black. It ain't until you look at your hand. You know,
certain people. Nah, I know I'm a black man when I walk outside.
I'm just saying, nigga, especially just California. Awesome. All right, shit, nigga. But like,
some of these niggas.
But yeah, I know what you're saying.
Nigga, I try to be like, we all men. You just seen what the fuck just happened with the motherfucker that just ran up in this grocery store and shot all the black people.
Bro, that shit had me hurt. Nigga.
So what I'm saying, we could all try to be, we ain't niggas, and we all men, and then we black men. No, we black men we first. Black.
Yeah.
And then right. We could be where the fuck we want to be after.
Right.
So if we want to be politically correct, I'm probably a black man first and a family man second and all the layers. But I'm saying we talking about just being at the improv.
Right.
You know, I'm a right. I'm a nigga to these people.
Right, right.
And I'm not devaluing myself, but I know how y'all. Yeah. I done heard niggas in our business.
But the
call me, oh my God, you're smarter than what I thought. So what me you too. Thought I was?
But white
a nigga.
But white you folks. See what I'm saying? White folks understand niggas better than most niggas do.
Facts.
That's why all the great comedians, the great greats, are niggas. Mm-hmm. Richard Pryor is a nigga.
Nigga grew Eddie, up in a brothel.
Nigga Eddie Murphy's a nigga. Nigga.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? Yeah, Bill Cosby's a nigga. Nigga.
Bernie Mac is a nigga.
Nigga. So it's like in our generation and a little bit before, there was this misconception that you had to be this crossover ass motherfucker. And that ain't what it is, bro. You just got to be strong enough to be who you are until your time comes.
You see what I'm saying?
You can't keep morphing into the hot nigga.
You see what I'm saying?
But these niggas ain't got it. These niggas lead with their insecurities, bro.
But I honestly think a lot of people really are who they trying to be. Right. I think our generation of comedy, I see everybody molded into who they really are. I think, you know, it's be waves and shit. And everybody try to adapt to the wave, but after the waves be like 2-3 years, and then people go into some whole other shit.
Right.
People be who are like who they are type shit.
Man, you know, I just think it depends. I get y'all generation is the most flexible because y'all appreciate more shit. I think. You know what I'm saying? Like in my generation of comedians, even though we've been doing it for about the same amount of time, but a lot of niggas.
Yeah, I was finna say, Kraig, you act like you just came up in the '80s or something.
But
nigga.
the thought,
you was at the same open mics, nigga.
Like, it real spit though. I started October 2010, so I ain't been doing this shit that long.
I started April 24th, 2010.
Yeah, he started before me. Mm-hmm. But you'll remember that it was certain niggas running around here thought you shouldn't cuss. I'm gonna be a clean comedian. That's the dumbest shit I ever heard in my fucking life, bro. Why you want to be a clean comedian? Because you think you'll get more opportunity?
Yeah.
That's not how that work, nigga.
They think they're going to be higher up the list. You got to be funny.
You got to be funny, bro. And funny requires a lot of risk and reward. Mm-hmm. Some nights you're going to kill. Mm-hmm. And some nights you may take a risk and try to work on some shit, and it may not go so great.
Facts.
The great niggas ain't scared of that process.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. In my opinion.
I feel you.
Because that's painful.
It is.
Because a lot of niggas, you know, they'll repeat a set that works and be like, good, I got it.
D-Ray just said that shit last Monday. That nigga was like, he was just basically on the stage basically saying why he like freestyling and why he like my style a lot, because it's just like niggas just talking shit sometimes too. Like, talking shit is funny. It's like, what made you realize a lot of motherfuckers just get a set and stand to it, but it's like that's not the naturally funny motherfuckers though. That's like by the book. It's so many by the book comedians where it's like it's so many of them you think, oh shit, I'm supposed to be by the book.
Niggas was, you know what made me get rid of my set? One, I kept losing my joke book. Two, niggas was biting.
Yeah, buddy.
Niggas, if they figure out your rhythm every time and figure out how you finna do shit, like...
Yeah, they gonna bite like a motherfucker.
Right, you just training the next nigga very well on how to tell your jokes in another city.
Damn.
And you'll never know.
That's what just happened to me.
Somebody was telling your jokes?
Nigga took... Nigga told the whole joke.
Who?
It's irrelevant. But we did a show, for sure. Yeah. And then, shit, we did a show... And then the next shit, 48 hours, this nigga saying my joke.
I had that shit happen in front of me. Damn. I think that's why I start seeing way out shit roasting stuff. Cause my set, my the next set I'm working on is just an hour of roasting.
That's
but
raw.
Turning the roast into bits.
Uh huh.
That's right. You know, 10 roasts and then a bit about a bit. 10 roasts. That's the style of my whole next shit. Mm-hmm. I've been seeing niggas saying some shit I just said 30 minutes ago.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? Yeah. But I don't even get mad about it no more because I know that I came up with a style where I'm going to take you in such deep waters that when a nigga do bite, y'all niggas going to be able to say in there, but that sound like some shit Kraig would say.
Exactly.
Yeah. And it's been happening like a motherfucker.
It's been happening. That's how you know you on something great.
So, you know, so all you biting ass niggas, it's cool. I ain't tripping, man. But my shit ain't Red Monkeys or Evizus, nigga. My shit going to get better and better. It ain't going to go out of style. So come up
I
with
I got
your
eczema,
own.
Nigga. I hope skin fall off your mouth. And choke you, nigga.
Hilarious.
That's hope crazy. A scab shoot down the back of your throat, nigga.
That's what you
every time you bite, nigga.
Hey, you know what ain't fair? I've been working on this. It's worked 2 out of 5 times.
What?
I got to choose bitches different. You know what I'm saying? Like, because I feel like women are getting more manly.
They are. And niggas is getting more feminine.
And like, I found out my bitch had a record. You know what I'm saying? I found out this bitch raped a nigga.
Whoa, I was finna say.
That ain't a bad thing. That's cool.
That nigga said, whoa.
What would you do if you found out?
That ain't a bad thing? Look.
What would you do if you found out your girl raped a nigga?
That's
rape
crazy.
Another nigga or rape?
Like he called you like, are you with Sean?
What
you
are we talking? We talking about like a, it ain't nothing wrong with a bitch being aggressive.
I'm talking about the bitch
dick.
Raped a nigga. Like she clobbered him and took the ass from him.
Oh! I didn't know it was that.
What would you do if you
what? Oh. You a sick nigga, Craig.
What if you found out your bitch was raping niggas, man?
Oh, hell nah.
You done.
That's what you ruined your rap.
You stay with her?
Nah, I mean, shit.
I like you a little
bit. You ain't raping me, nigga.
This nigga's stupid.
But look, that's the
difference. I tried to pay the bitch bail.
Bruh.
But that's how different shit is now, man. That's the mentality. Like, things that seem like impossible are really happening every day now, nigga.
Bro, they just had a congressional hearing about 150 UFO sightings, nigga, that they've been seeing and ain't telling us, nigga. Mm. Come on, bro.
That's
I know they done slapped the air tracker on them UFOs, nigga, and well, see them where they went.
Yeah, I see.
I'm afraid of the future for sure. This
is don't be afraid, nigga. Just keep getting that bread.
I seen the UFO get repoed, nigga.
Huh?
I seen the UFO get repoed, nigga. Bruh. That was crazy to see.
You think they still like catalytic converters, nigga? Nigga, they gonna strip the fuck out of a UFO.
You know what I feel like was really going on in life? I feel like it's a curtain somewhere like this. Mm-hmm. That you could pull it back, mm-hmm. and they're watching us live this life. Like, nigga,
yeah.
you might be up for an Oscar in a different dimension right now, not even know it, nigga. Your performance... You out of your mind. You don't even know you perform. Like, I feel like it's something is watching us do what we doing right now.
I ain't gonna lie. It's something going on. I feel you. I see where you going. Because everything getting hella expensive. Gas finna be damn near $10. And you know they talking about making the, you know, they already over there on the other planet. Jeff Bezos and them niggas. They talking about going on the other planet. They been going back and forth.
Funded by the government.
That's what I'm saying. They probably... If you probably left on this earth in like 2060 or something, you probably ass.
See, I think that
we're gonna have to leave this motherfucker in a minute.
Corona was a union strike on the other side. Wherever the other side is, the writers and behind the scene niggas was on strike. You feel me? So they said it was Corona, but really
the writers of the earth.
Writers of whoever watching this was on strike. It's something deeper going on, bro.
And that's why everybody hopped on their phones.
They had motherfuckers running, bro. This shit was crazy, bro. That pandemic shit, 2020. Bro, motherfuckers just acting like that shit just wasn't just some crazy shit, bro. Bro,
niggas got rich and poor.
And rich and same.
We still in the beginning phases of this shit,
yeah.
bro. Shit going up a little bit. Motherfuckers panicking, nigga. It's going to go up some more.
And then it's going to crash.
That's just show.
And then it's going to be a little low-key purge.
Man.
That's you don't think the pandemic was a fake mini, almost mini little baby purge?
No, it's finna be an official one with flyers.
Nigga, after party.
Yeah, nigga, radio sponsored, big boy. What up, it's your partner, big boy, letting y'all know.
I don't know what the point of the purge. I guess to give you a day to commit whatever crime.
To whatever crime you want.
The bathroom is a
all
purge.
These smash and grabs and shit, nigga, that's purging.
The bathroom is a purge.
What you mean by the bathroom?
Shitting.
Think about this, bro. Why are there doorknobs? Up until, just not, bathroom is, just listen, follow me. Mm-hmm. Up until.
You want feet knobs?
Up until the 1800s, doctors didn't even wash their hands before they did surgery. And the life expectancy of the average human was like 30, 40 years old. Mm-hmm. And we start washing our hands.
Right.
And a lot of people think that's why we live longer, right? Mm-hmm. So I think that governments don't want us to live as long, so they create doorknobs because they know we got to touch shit. Mm-hmm. And how do you spread germs?
Yeah.
Through touching shit.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? Uh-huh. And a lot of motherfuckers ain't going to wash their hands after they touch everything. Like you may touch two things and wash your hand once. So what's the point of that if you touch something, then get your hands dirty, and then don't wash them after that. You feel what I'm saying?
Didn't Bill Gates say that shit on the interview? He said, so one of them motherfuckers said that shit.
Really?
On the interview, they said, before the pandemic happened, it was like the U.S. or the world ain't ready for, like, fucking corona, basically. You're saying, like, you know, motherfuckers.
Yeah, Bill Gates was having, like,
it was
a
Bill
talk.
Gates, right?
Yeah,
he was basically saying, yeah, nigga, the way you really shut this motherfucker down is, nigga, through germs, not through guns and... you know how motherfuckers come in and try to fuck something up? Nah, nigga, if they hit us with some shit like corona, nigga, we'd be fried. And that's exactly what happened.
If it wasn't no doorknobs, like, you should have to do everything with your feet. When you want to get in the bathroom door, you should have to.
Yeah, they got little feet things now. I've been seeing
them. When you want to wash your hands, feet. When you want to flush the toilet, feet. Mm. But you got to touch everything. And that's how they quarantine us. Niggas who don't have weak immune systems, they get to touching everything and they out of there eventually.
Yeah.
But low key, niggas who touch everything be living longer. Y'all niggas on the street, them niggas is out there touching the world.
Knox be 89.
Nigga.
Nigga on the street.
I pull up and they, 240 on their dash.
Hey.
All niggas love that song.
Door knobs, nigga.
Y'all think that corona shit went away?
Hell no. It's going up now, nigga. Variants coming out.
What I'm saying is motherfuckers ain't really pushing issues like that.
I almost didn't come to this podcast.
Motherfuckers ain't pushing issue.
They not?
Bruh.
Because niggas want their bread, bro. They been tired.
Bro, we was really on some in the house shit. Everybody scared to go outside with masks. The vaccine, so you think the vaccine worked?
I don't. You know what? A few people have died.
Because they let Kyrie Irving play basketball. Yeah. It's like if everybody's standing what they standing on, Kyrie shouldn't be able to play.
I just think it's I agree. I think it's I don't know, bro.
Cause I got my vaccine. I feel like I done got played. These niggas done played me out. They done shot some shit in me, nigga. And I don't even need to show the card no more.
No more. That shit, you only needed it for like 6 months.
Yeah.
And niggas was showing the fake vaccine. So
nigga, I might be turning green in 2030. Some shit. Nigga, they gonna have probably to put some shit in me.
Whatever's next is gonna be crazy.
I ain't putting nothing else in me, nigga. I don't give a fuck about no booster, none of that.
Cause that corona shit, fuck the disease. Just all the shit that was happening, them shutting everything down.
That fuck niggas' heads up, bro. Everybody's mind. It's gonna be a lot more mass shootings, a lot more crazy shit. Niggas is like, oh, when is it gonna stop? Peace, you know, kumbaya and all that shit. No, nigga.
The pandemic changed.
Yeah. You know what they need to do to keep people safe publicly? They need to take the boom out of guns. You know, when you shoot, boom.
Yeah.
They need to put a cry. Because if I heard a nigga, oh, like a gun crying, I feel like more people would get away. Because they would be like, what the fuck is that crying, nigga? You know what I'm saying? The gun ain't popping, the gun is crying. Put a different sound in the gun.
I don't know.
You know what I'm saying? I don't know, man. We got to do some different
shit. I feel you on that. Not with the crying. But it got...
Yeah, that's why I leaned back. I was like, oh, no.
The gun, I ain't gonna lie. Guns got the right sound. Pow! That make a motherfucker move,
that
boy.
Make a nigga run. It do. It do. It do.
Nigga, gunshots is smirk.
But you would feel like such a bitch if your gun cried. Niggas would view you as a whiner, not a killer. This nigga always crying.
You just seen them niggas had a shootout at 7-Eleven?
Where at?
in like Whittier or something. It was Spanish on Spanish crime. And niggas like, hey, what's up, S.A.? Niggas saw each other at the door.
They probably didn't say, what's up, S.A.? That was racist.
No.
If I'm lying. Two Mexicans walking about, what's up, S.A.?
What's up, fool?
That was racist.
That was what it is. They said, what's up, S.A.? What's up, fool? It was one of them.
It probably was fool. Mexicans don't even say S.A. no more.
And then them niggas just start dumping on each other, bro.
That's wild.
In the 7-Eleven, nigga, like.
Somebody got hit.
Nah.
Hey, people at home watching, do Mexicans still say S.A.?
Yeah, they be like, dead, fool.
They say nigga. Fool.
Fuck that, fool.
Mexicans say nigga now.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
They be like, hey, my nigga.
Oh, my mama.
I be like, whoa.
S.A.'s have changed.
Yeah, Mexicans don't say S.A.'s no more. Yeah.
They show you a picture of their brother, shit. Like, my brother black, fool.
Yeah, they be having cousins and shit. S.A.'s is cool little motherfucker, man.
Mexicans in the Bay always acted black in my time.
For real, not out here.
Yeah, Mexicans in L.A. really act Mexican.
Yeah, no, they're like real S.A.'s out here.
They fuck around.
They act like S.A.'s.
Yeah.
I'm talking about a lot of the newer ones. Younger niggas, younger ones.
But the ones that I grew up around, the motherfuckers was not.
Y'all closer to Mexico, nigga. I was just in Tulum, nigga. It was nigga talking about, yeah, what's up, my nigga? He's like, yeah, I spent time in Long Beach. Like, damn, that nigga was in Tulum.
That nigga said I spent time in Long Beach. Like it was a hell of a place.
Nigga, it mattered to me. I'm real, nigga. Oh, you know English? Nigga, I'm Jewish. I locked in with that nigga.
I spent time in Long Beach.
I'm like, yeah, nigga, I slammed through there too, man. It's always the truth. That's me. Nigga was chopping game, nigga. Your place the only nigga speak English out here, nigga. Oh, mamas, nigga. I'm like, what y'all got going on? I showed that nigga some weed, hella shit. I'm like, I got this Sonic Blow, nigga. I whipped out on that nigga hella shoes, like, oh yeah, I need that. I'm like, yeah, all right, nigga.
Nigga, 50. Nigga.
Yeah, I need my cheese, nigga.
Nigga, 300,000 pesos?
Yeah, on my mom, I was to tax that nigga 8,000 for
you
this bag.
Buy some pussy in Mexico?
Hell no, I went out there with some lovely, beautiful brown skin. On mama's for the first time.
How was that?
I had a blast.
Oh, you was tricking.
Nah, I was keeping it pee. You know what I'm saying? having a great time on some birthday celebration shit.
Oh yeah, happy birthday, man.
Yeah, you know happy what I'm birthday,
saying?
Man.
I appreciate it, man. God damn me. It's a blessing to be 28, you know what I'm saying? Feeling great, 28. Instead of me. But it was cool. I had a good time. I did zip lining. Hey,
tell the truth, was this the first year you felt like I'm really damn near the only nigga that cared about my birthday this year?
Nah.
Like on some grown nigga shit.
Oh, what you mean? Like, I cared about my birthday?
Like, you know, like, it get to a point, nigga, where it just be your birthday. It just for, like, whoever's closest to you.
That's it, nigga.
Nah, like,
I've been there.
Like, you didn't really post it or, you know, it's like, I don't know if you posted it or whatever, but.
I posted it. I don't know. I don't be.
It just be getting to a point where
birthday.
It just be like, whoever here, that's who I'm celebrating with, nigga. And,
I'm near Teddy. I'm with you. I've been here, bro.
Damn.
It just out of nowhere. You know what's weird? Like as you,
I used to go all out, invite niggas, and want people to pull. You know, like
I never done that. This is my first time. I feel like this is the most effort I ever put into my birthday this year.
Yeah, oh, for real?
Dope, yeah. I didn't.
Well,
my
you was going out of town. You was going out the country, really.
What? Just previously.
Nah, I just feel like on my.
But I'm saying for your birthday, you went out the country.
Yeah. Like I really. Planned on to do something, so it's like that was my first time ever doing it. I enjoyed it.
I think the pandemic was played a part of that.
Yeah,
pandemic realized, nigga, I ain't did shit, but nigga, travel the world on some comedy shit, nigga. I ain't never just went nowhere and had a good time, nigga.
Yeah,
had a good time as I work.
Yeah,
but now it's a good time, so that's why I did it. So I'm like, let me put always, nigga. My birthday always sneak up on me.
Yeah,
always,
yeah.
Nigga. Shit, nigga. All right, let's go bowling or something, nigga. Yeah. What y'all niggas doing, like?
I fucked around and accepted a gig on my birthday last year.
For real?
That'd be cool, though. I love
it. I love, that's what I'm saying. I was happy. Mm-hmm. But then I was like, damn, I kind of wanted to be somewhere just chilling.
Uh-huh.
You know, at the same time. Like, but let's get on with this show, nigga. How y'all doing?
I performed on my birthday. My shit landed
too,
on the 9th. I mean, my shit landed on a Monday. So I had to do the improv. So I did it. I did it right. Because I'm like, all right, boom. I did my little player shit. Calm shit out the way, and then I perform. So I fucked with it. I think I'm gonna keep doing it.
Why not?
I think I got to keep doing something for my birthday.
It ain't nothing wrong with it.
Right, every year, go crazy.
But, you know, at a certain point, I don't know if you went through this yet, like, when you be pursuing your dreams and shit, it's always a few people that's disappointed that you can't do what you used to do with them. You know what I'm talking about?
Right.
Like, they be, you know, they call you, be busy, or they don't understand that you be working. They think that when you say I'm busy or I can't get back, you know what I mean? They thinking it personal. That's what's hard to deal with, motherfuckers that fuck with you getting the wrong idea.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? How you niggas deal with that?
You just gotta, you know, just keep doing what's best for you, really. Mashing, and, you know, I pray you see that this is going to be best for all of us at some point. Because right. If I can get to where I need to get to. Because a lot of times that, what we used to do, like a lot of the homies and shit, nigga, we would just sit on the block and smoke all day, sun up to sundown.
Right.
And, like, that just don't serve me no more, nigga, like. I'll smoke sun up and sundown, but it'll be around creatives,
right?
Or
right.
It'll be around people that's doing shit, like
right.
You know, I gotta be around shit that's moving,
yeah.
Motion. We just sitting still, nigga, just talking about old shit, nigga. And bitches used to come suck dicks in the alley, and nigga, just like
that shit get old.
People such and such came suck our nigga in the alley. Like, yeah, that shit was cool, nigga, that day, nigga.
Niggas always talking with their head, future and shit, so they dwelling on the past.
Man, that's
I don't like all that shit.
No, it ain't nothing to that, man.
I feel like the older I get, the more I don't know, but I always kind of been like, I've been working on my people skills. I'm kind of like antisocial, so it come out the wrong way if you talk to motherfuckers like a lot.
Yeah.
And then it's like your birthday, and then you don't talk to somebody, like, I'd have spent the birthday by myself, like, on some, like, nigga, I don't call, like, I was on some, nigga, I wasn't calling, checking up on motherfuckers and do all that shit.
That's so, what I was saying, like, okay, so you had that happened, a birthday already.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. Bro, on some, I'm only worried about what I gotta do type shit, so I'm on that the whole year, nigga, so when my birthday come about, nigga, now everybody posted, I got going on. So I'm like, nigga, that shit brought me, like, to awareness, like, oh, shit, let me start checking up on motherfuckers and shit like that. Like, my social skills getting better the older I get, nigga. I was on some very self-centered. Not selfish, self-centered.
Right.
So, you know.
Because all you know is you for so many years.
You feel me?
And then
my shit like, going in reverse.
Oh, huh? Really?
Yeah. But they not getting worse. Like I said, you realize everybody full of shit.
Yeah.
It's some motherfuckers that only tell you happy birthday because they want something in return.
Or they only say hello or whatever.
They want something in return. So if you're not giving them what they want, they're going to stop talking to you.
I ain't going to lie. That's why I fuck with my pop so heavy, because that nigga laced me when I was a little nigga about that shit. Just about, you know, my dad never been, he never taught me to run with niggas and, you know, tell niggas your business and just, you know, because he always just laced me like on some, like, nigga, you know, at the end of the day, you know, niggas always got a little agenda,
right?
You know, so he always just, you know, you catch my dad, nigga, he always would tell me, nigga, I don't, nigga, my pops be by himself or nigga with his wife, nigga, my mama, nigga, so he always be quick to tell niggas I don't sleep with niggas, you feel me? So I thought he was I thought he was over exaggerating, you know.
It's just starting to get cotton mouth.
But the older I get, the more I realize why OGs really be having wives and shit.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, nigga, I get it. It makes sense, cause niggas.
So help mate.
Niggas gonna go with the bitch. Niggas gonna go trick off on some pussy. Niggas gonna get some money and start acting different. At the end of the day,
she gonna be there.
I ain't gonna say she gonna be there. You gotta be there for yourself.
Right. That's real shit.
You feel me? Motherfuckers be wanting other people to love them more than they love themselves.
Man.
People make self-love like it's like a negative thing. Like, oh, you full of yourself. Are you, no, nigga, I love me more than I love everybody, nigga.
And you gotta get out.
I love me and I love everybody.
That's some real shit, bro.
But I can't love y'all if I don't love me.
Man. Hey. Cause my love for you is gonna be weak. You gonna be like, damn, nigga, you only love yourself a little bit.
You see what I'm saying?
Hey, man, I'm gonna tell you, being around too many niggas, you gonna waste a lot of good ideas. Cause every nigga wants to control his own destiny.
Uh-huh.
And it's in us to figure out how much we worth or what our value is. It's in us to base it on other niggas sometimes. Uh-huh. You may be around niggas and you comparing, okay, what's my opinion in comparison to his? And now you niggas is arguing over dumbass ideas, trying to show another, you understand what I'm saying? Yeah. But when it's a woman there, not uh-huh. just a regular bitch, but a woman, uh-huh. she can help you cultivate those ideas. Like, baby, I think I want to start a comedy night. Okay, well how can I help you?
Yeah.
Where a nigga want to try to be boss over his shit and your shit.
Yep.
So you got to really be careful. Pops, that's some ill shit Pops did.
Yeah, nah, so that's why, you know, always. And then you get more opportunities being around women. I don't want to give these niggas too much game. But these my folks, the Cali Kickbackers. But, you know, it's hard to get in those with four niggas. You can go anywhere with a woman, nigga.
Right.
Mama's nigga.
That's that balance, though, because you still need goons.
You can have just as many guns with them four bitches that you had with your niggas.
I was just finna say that, nigga.
All that on
goons is hammers.
Would you join a gang?
Niggas keep me safe.
Would you join a gang?
Niggas are telling you.
Would you join a gang that had a female leader?
Yeah, they get on some Zamunda shit.
Damn, that's a good question. Nah.
Like the Black Panthers, like a
me, I'm not no gang nigga, so I don't give a fuck if it was a nigga, I'm not joining no gang.
But I'm just saying, like, on some black, if it's like some black people shit, yeah.
I'm talking about it's
what we doing?
We gangbanging.
Oh, nah. We gangbanging and she the run.
And the leader got ass and titties. I mean, thick as a motherfucker.
I be fucking with the bitch and damn near be managing the whole operation. And these niggas don't even know I'm the nigga that's really running the shit. I'm fucking with the bitch.
Like Cash Doll, the leader. The leader.
Right now. Like Cash Doll. Kim Kardashian. That's the leader. One of them type of motherfuckers.
I ain't following no Kim Kardashian.
Yeah. I'm not joining. Bitch, I ain't these niggas. So, bitch, what we need to do is I want to fuck with what you got going on with your gang.
Right.
And let's run this play. Let's send these niggas over here.
Right, right.
I'm not finna have these. That's like a pimp. The bitch pimping the niggas.
So, are you saying that it's not possible for a woman to lead you?
No, I'm not saying that.
Okay, what you saying?
I'm saying is I'm not finna have no gang member fucking tell me where to go and all shit. Right, it's right. A female. Yeah. I'm not nigga or bitch, I'm not on that. But
what if your wife asks you to marry her? You gonna marry her? Nah. You with a girl she got on her knees and proposed to you. No,
like
why
Jim
not?
Jones, his lady did that.
I feel it, but nah. I feel it, but nah. That's just too. I got this thing. You with me. I'm not with you. Whatever woman I'm be, you with me. I'm not with. No. So, I don't know. It may be just some alpha shit. Because I just can't see myself following the lead.
Yeah.
Of even if I'm with my mom. I'm a grown ass man. My mama with me. I'm not with my mama. You
feel me? Mama gonna stand behind me.
Mama, like, hey, mom, we doing this and this what we I gotta go holler at this dude and we gotta do this and you know what I'm saying?
If some
now,
shit go down, like nigga.
My mama with me. I'm not mama. Nah, hey, mom, what's going on? Hold on. You know what I'm saying? So I just with a woman, no. I feel like I'm a king. I feel like I'm a king and I feel like I can.
Like a woman can't protect you.
I think that's men's job is to protect our women.
What about you? Protect one of you.
I feel like a woman will do a sometimes better job at protection than niggas can. Just off attention to detail.
Right.
Now, it's up to the nigga if he pay attention to his woman. I feel, Lou, it's your job to lead, nigga, and you with me. But because you with me, that means I trust you and you smart.
Exactly.
So I'm going to listen to you.
Yeah, your opinion matter like a motherfucker.
I'm going to listen to you. Now look me in the eye and tell me, should I shoot this nigga or not?
Right.
No? Okay, I would give a lot of time.
If you put me in a position where I got to shoot a nigga over you, I don't want to be with you.
Not even that. I'm just talking about like a nigga break in or something like whatever. Like whatever. But like
if a nigga break in, my instinct, we ain't talking. My bitch, you already know what's going on. This shit over with. You already know what it is. So she,
but you know, if you follow a nigga out your house, that's more time than if you just shoot a nigga inside your house.
I would want my woman. So this is what I would want my.
But
woman
I'm leave. Just talking bullshit. But like, I'm
take leave. Stop me from leaving this house if it's a possibility. If you see me putting me, my family, anything in jeopardy, try to prevent it.
But I'm just saying, you know, nigga, when you be hot, you be. When a nigga mad and in the moment, sometimes you ain't thinking about that shit.
That's a fact.
I'm stable.
That's a fact.
So yeah. I need Shorty to know the what's best for me.
Right.
Uh-huh.
You know?
If all
and what's best for me is going to be what's best for us.
Straight up.
Facts. Because she with you.
Would you let your girl have a male best friend, a new male best friend, like she... You've been with her 5 years. She just met the nigga a year ago.
Hell no.
No.
Would you?
Hell motherfucking no.
Y'all put a comment, would you? Top it, nigga.
Bestie!
You think your woman supposed to protect you in a physical way?
I mean, here's the thing, right?
Mm-hmm. It goes both ways. We're supposed to love and protect each other.
Lionesses do it.
Talk that shit.
That's a fact.
So the balance in nature is not always linear. Like, humans have this ego where we think that shit always happens in a certain way.
Mm-hmm.
Like, we think that we're the most technologically advanced society ever. Mm-hmm. But this shit may have already happened 2,000 years ago and everything got destroyed. We don't know that.
That's why them UFOs keep surrounding us, nigga. Them is alien drones.
But you feel what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. This shit could have already happened.
Mm-hmm.
Cause think about this, up until this point in your life, how much shit you've seen happen again. We like, goddamn.
Yeah.
So you think it just that type of shit?
Nah.
You know what I'm saying? So, so there may be a woman out there capable of.
If your female had a motorcycle, you getting on her back, on the back of the motorcycle?
No. Don't fiend that, bitch. You don't get the fuck off this bike, bitch. I'm going to tell you one thing, you manly bitch. I'm never riding behind you, bitch. You better go on and relax one time and go.
That's the same shit
on.
I'm talking about.
You feel what I'm saying?
That's the same shit.
No.
You know?
That's the same shit.
We you talking about her, putting
you with
guns
her if
and
you
purses.
Get on that bike. If she get on your bike, she with you.
We talking about she sees some shit I don't see, nigga. She start busting.
Oh, that's cool. I fuck with that all day.
Yeah, I mean, women. Yeah.
But if you see it, you don't need to run and tell her.
Baby, I gotta go.
No, just also, like, she got the strap.
Oh.
Like, nah, give me my strap. Yo, my strap and your shit. I'm not borrowing your strap. No,
we got the strap.
Nigga, I got strap and it's in your shit. Now you got your own strap, but I'm always at my strap.
Right.
I'm just saying, and what's the shit you say? I'm not saying all this shit be going on, but yeah, you see what I'm saying?
These are hypothetical straps, y'all.
Exactly.
Would you give your girl a pass to fuck another nigga?
No.
Is there ever a scenario where you'd be like, you know what, baby? I feel like you're used to my dick.
Never.
And I want
what you going through, Kraig?
I love you so much. Mm-hmm. That I let you let another nigga smash.
Nah, this the one I'm fucking with.
Your girl.
Nah, I ain't fucking with that. No. You fucking with that?
They don't know, but what I'm saying is this. It would make
so why are you asking us?
It would make us better men.
No, it would not.
Mm-mm. Letting other niggas fuck your girl would make you a better nigga, Teddy. Don't be fooled.
How is that
successful? Because sex shouldn't be as important as it is.
I agree on that.
You feel what I'm saying? Like, it's the last thing that matters. Because you can get it from any bitch. So covet something that you can get from any bitch. I need to covet things that are
irreplaceable.
If you want to
get some new dick,
do that. Holla,
go live with that nigga. Go stay with that man.
For real?
Go be with him.
What if he's doing better? What if he got more money than you? Y'all need some bills paid.
Hey, no, nigga.
I ain't got shit to do with ism.
Yeah.
You can go get that money from that nigga and don't have to fuck.
That's what I'm saying. What if she's just hanging out with the nigga?
It matters the relationship we got going on.
But you talking about the one. I don't want my one on
bitches
like that.
I don't want my bitch to be doing none of that coin.
For real?
My mama.
I'm on some shit.
Now,
nigga,
if I'm fucking around, and her fucking around is finessing some niggas on some cheese.
If that's what you about, yeah, let's go run this nigga.
But you, but what, how would you feel about your girl going to church and giving your money to a pastor? You cool with that?
I don't fuck with that shit.
But would you fuck with a broad that's cool with that?
She got to give 10% of her earnings.
It matters what she giving me. She can get a pastor, whatever. Long as you ain't getting the pastor money what you giving me. So right. If you get that nigga $10, I should be getting at least a band at the minimum.
Right.
So if I'm getting a band and you go to church and you feeling good, you get this nigga $10, we cool. But you ain't finna be.
This some bay nigga math. If you get a pastor $10, I should at least get a band.
But okay, so what if every time
I'm dead serious.
What I don't get about the preacher thing, why niggas is cool with their broad going and sitting up under another nigga. You feel me? Because it's still a nigga at the
it's
end of the day.
It's the nigga screaming.
If you was
screaming and sweating.
If every time you walked into a room, I was telling your bitch what's right and wrong. Bitch, yeah. You know you shouldn't be doing that. Yeah. You go on and do bitches wrong.
Yeah.
You gonna be like, nigga, who the fuck is you talking about?
Who the fuck
bro?
Is you? Oh, my
but
mom.
A bitch could go to church and a nigga that you barely know could tell her how to operate in your relationship. Yeah. How to feel and
how
all that.
Feel, how he's supposed to be treating you.
That's
how
worse than letting
feeling.
A nigga fuck your bitch.
Facts. And he didn't end it. She didn't pay the P.
Man.
The P is the preacher.
And
man.
She pay him every time she seen, man.
P paid that nigga. Screaming, crying all type of shit.
It costs
because
a fee
this
to
nigga
fuck
talking.
With me.
That nigga charging a fee to fuck with him.
At least a nigga that's just fucking her gonna get up and go home.
On mama.
You feel me? This
that's
bitch, you know what I mean? It's like, nigga, the world
so
is
so church
twisted.
Is worse than cheating.
Church is worse than adultery.
Wow. Mm.
It's worse than adultery. Should no other man have a word as strong as yours in your woman's life? Period. You ain't never going to win that
that's
way,
why you
got
to be the pastor.
You got to be.
I'm the pastor of my house.
That's what I'm saying. That matter. Y'all seen the press that talk about Kevin Samuels? How y'all feel about that?
Well, he was
but how y'all
props?
Feel about people just disrespecting this man in general?
Kevin Samuels is a
nigga,
god.
He a legend. R.P. Kevin Samuels. I like, fuck with him. Nigga, I'm a high value man. Nigga, I know what the fuck you talking about.
I'm gonna lose his stomach. But I did see your episode on that. Yeah. I am gonna lose his stomach.
But he go back to that pussy being overvalued. He's just
for sure. Just for sure.
Adjusting the price of pussy.
Facts.
You niggas are paying $50 a gallon in gas if it was pussy.
Mm-hmm.
Right, when you should be paying a dollar.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying? So all he did, he was a pussy adjuster, and I respect him. Rest in peace. The problem with women is accountability.
Yeah.
They think that being a bad bitch with big titties and ass is enough. No, bitch, pussy is not enough. Let me tell you how worthless pussy is. Mm. Pussy is so worthless that lesbians don't buy pussies. They buy dicks. When last time you seen a porno with two bitches fucking each other with a fake pussy? Bitches is buying dicks.
But dicks so bunk, niggas don't be selling they shit though.
Right, because they don't.
Bitches be selling pussy and niggas be buying it.
Right.
So pussy got clout. Yeah. Let's not play with the pussy.
Yeah.
Because it always, you know, it's going to be the most interesting thing on the earth till the earth done.
But men got to realize that it's more women out here than men. Niggas go to jail, niggas be dying, all type of shit. Bitches is out here.
Right.
So niggas be doing all this shit. You don't have to do that. If we all stood on 10 toes and dropped our nuts and be like, hey man, you know what I'm talking about, value ourselves more as men,
right.
Women would treat us better. But because you got so many trick ass niggas to do anything for some vagina that now bitches is talking crazy.
Yeah, that's real spit.
So it's like, that's what Kevin Samuels was basically standing on too. He was like, nigga, it's more women. He understood that. He was like a bad nigga that was better vocabulary, nigga. He was like, this nigga was saying what all niggas in the Bay been trying to tell the world. Now niggas get a little ism. Now niggas pushing P. This ain't the play.
Man.
Pushing P ain't the play. The play is keeping it P, man. You understand me?
And that mean not lying.
Stop lying. Stop tricking. And hold yourself to some motherfucking value. It's okay to spend some bread on your woman. Have a good time.
Let's spend money to have a good time.
That ain't tricking. Yeah.
That's not tricking.
Let's see something new.
If you're paying prices. For the activity, that's not tricking. You having a good time, you probably pay for it.
It depends on why you're tricking.
That's a good point.
If you're spending money to make her happy, that's tricking.
You're tricking.
No, I always wanted to go to the fucking San Diego Zoo.
Yeah, there we go.
You feel me? I'm going for myself. Yes. I've been wanting to talk to this for a while.
Bitch, we both want to go to the Miami Heat game.
Hey, cause I know.
So I'm buying the tickets. But bitch, if you want to go get your motherfucking nipples done, I'm not paying for that.
You got to be a good person. Look, you can't be a good bitch unless you follow him behind a nigga.
Facts.
If you're not, you good at being a bad bitch. Good bitches take orders, man. It ain't no renegade in the animal kingdom. Bitch, you got to fall in line with something male. Whether it's a bitch that's dressed like a nigga or a nigga, you got to fall in line with something masculine. that's just the way in nature. I'm not creating these laws. You feel what I'm saying?
No, real shit, though.
And that's how it goes, nigga. Period, point blank.
Fall in line.
So all you niggas at home, nigga, the woman is with you. All you niggas being with the woman, that's why the game all fucked up. Nigga, anytime you see me with a woman, nigga, she with me.
Beautiful.
Nigga, on mamas, nigga. Beautiful. And if the bitch ain't listening to what we on, you don't have to be with me.
Yeah, I'm a
because it's more women than men.
Right.
And they know that.
They know that. Yo niggas been in jail. Yo
that's
niggas,
why that bitch straight.
Every bitch to fuck with a nigga that's in jail then or died. I'm not saying everybody, but it's a lot in our community. Right. That's why a lot of people not fortunate to have fathers and shit. A lot of people fucking arrested, killed, all type of shit. Nigga, it's hard being a black man.
Man. Right.
So bitch, you gonna devalue me? And when it's nigga, I'm special to be alive as a black man.
Right.
Bitch, I'm already special. Don't try to act like I'm just a nigga. Now that's where the just being a nigga. Now I'm that nigga. Bitch, if I'm alive and I'm in this motherfucking chopping game with you, I'm that nigga, bitch.
Hey, man. Cause
a lot of niggas didn't make it.
A lot of niggas ain't even here. Niggas didn't die. Niggas went arrested. Some niggas ain't even got the cheese to even be here.
Yeah.
Bitch, I don't give a fuck. I got $5 in my pocket. Bitch, I could afford to be here though.
Yeah, right.
I'm talking about I'm still in this motherfucker.
We in the same room.
We in the same room, nigga.
That's
I'm
how
here.
I used to feel about the bad bitches and shit. I pull up with the holes in my chucks.
Oh,
we be in the same club. I'm like, bitch.
Yeah.
You know what I used to
do? I just got 2 million views this week and you talking shit to me.
You know I used to do with bad bitches when I was a young, immature nigga? I see a bad bitch, I get her attention and I'd be like, bitches be like,
you thinking it's a booger and all
no,
that.
No, I was cocaine.
Oh, cocaine. Hey, this nigga's sick.
All the bad bitches on cocaine.
I'm going to tell you the coldest thing a bad bitch ever did to me. I went and got an AIDS test after this.
Mm. Ah, this nigga finna say some wild shit.
I'm in the club. I see a bad chocolate bitch like I like him. Thick as a motherfucker. Just everywhere. Curves everywhere, nigga.
Yeah.
I get to dancing with her. I'm being real flirty. She flirting back. She pull her titty out. What she do is she squeeze breast milk out her titty and put it on her finger and wipe it in my mouth.
Oh. You at the club?
I'm at the club.
Doing
baby.
The same old two step.
I'm in the.
What?
The bitch leave like she go to the bathroom and disappear. And I call my sister. I'm like, guess what happened to me today? And I told her, she's like, that's bodily fluid, nigga. You better go get a test. That's like, nigga, if you swallow a bitch breast milk, that's like hitting without a condom on.
You
nigga.
Lying?
Yes, nigga.
You knew that?
I didn't know about
it's
that
bodily
part.
Fluid.
Is that a fact, y'all?
It's bodily fluid.
I done sucked breast milk before.
Really?
One
you
time.
A nasty ass nigga.
One time.
What?
She walked from where her baby was. Where her baby was dropped off with me,
mm-hmm.
And I just was like. You walked from where your baby was at? I don't know. Something about her being on foot made me be like, man, give me this titty.
Suck the titty.
See what this baby be drinking.
So you got to get tested if that shit's
true. It was years ago. I've been straight, nigga. My test came back straight.
I'm getting stronger by the day, shit.
Damn. I ain't done a lot of shit.
I'm lactose. I should have probably did it. That's for that.
Are you thinking we lactose when it comes to human milk? Or is that just cow milk?
I don't know, but I fuck with almond milk. If y'all want to give me a sponsorship,
go crazy.
That shit getting pricey.
Hey, got to pay.
I like
money.
My cereal.
Have you ever had a celebrity moment off of being famous on the internet where you're like, damn, that's my, that shit crazy. I can't believe that happened to me. Like for me, it was being outside the Improv. Uh-huh. I'm standing next to Bill Bellamy. Uh-huh. I don't really know the nigga that well, but I know you, Bill Bellamy. Uh-huh. A motherfucker come out. Oh shit. My favorite comedian. Right, Bill Bellamy said it right next to me. Mm-hmm. And like, hey man, can you hold my camera so I can get a picture? And they handed the camera to Bill Bellamy. Like, I want to take it. Kraig Smith from Roast Me.
Wow. But no, I know what you told me.
That shit tripped me out, bro. That shit
is crazy.
I had Party Next Door leave. Like a circle of bitches, bro. It was Kylie Jenner over there. Hella different model bitches that I just only see on IG. Mm-hmm. Who come tell me I was funny.
Oh, that's fire.
I was like, you left all them hoes to come tell me I'm funny.
Yeah.
Salute to you, King.
Oh, mama.
Appreciate that, nigga.
Oh, mama.
That's what's up.
I ain't gonna lie. I'm gonna be able to say this. It's more, I think it was more, it tripped me out with motherfuckers. When I started performing, like, with the OGs and shit. Like, you know the Tony Roberts, the Mike Epps, you know, all of them. Yeah. And, you know, after the show, motherfuckers is, you know, like, really standing on me. Like, nigga, you was my favorite, and you my favorite. I came to see you on the...
Yeah.
Like, whoa. That's like, fire. Nigga, what, nigga? Like, it be awkward. Like, damn, nigga.
Yeah.
I fuck with it, but it be like, well, damn, nigga, shit.
Man, all right.
Like, damn, all right. I'm glad you felt this way.
Yeah, they make you... That should be inspiring, though.
Yeah,
you
know, that shit I gotta crazy.
Keep mastering.
It make you see the game for what it really is.
Yeah. Like, man. Have you ever had a... Oh, well, we all had those moments. Have you ever had a moment where it's like you thought you was that nigga and then you wasn't? You thought you was at the moment?
It happened for me in rap.
Uh-huh. Because
I had 5 albums before I ever told a joke.
Mm-hmm.
And I rented this spot called the Zen Lounge to throw a show.
Uh-huh.
It held like 500. I got like 5,000 flyers made, passed them out, and on the day of the show, nigga, probably like 15 people showed up.
Mm-hmm. Traumatizing.
Instead of rhyming, I just bagged on niggas.
Wow.
Because I was so disappointed, and that's how I got in the stand-up.
Yeah.
You funky doghead bitch.
Yeah, buddy.
I ain't gonna lie, I was on the red carpet one time for this event, and I was getting a lot of love and shit, right? So then this girl was like on the carpet and she like started screaming. She like, oh my God, woo, right? She walking right in my direction, right? So I'm thinking she talking to me. Nigga, I turn around, this nigga Mayweather right behind me. Icy as fuck. I'm like, whoo.
Hey, Mayweather real star.
I'm like, boy.
You thought the love was for you?
I'm like, yeah, I lost my damn mind over here on this carpet.
That nigga bought me a burger. Shout out to Mayweather.
That's that nigga Mayweather, oh boy.
I seen that nigga pay a bitch rent in the club.
I was there. No, it was at the show, bro.
At the show,
1500.
Comedy club, yeah.
Yep.
I be saying the club, like how niggas be talking about the club. Like,
oh, the comedy club. Yeah.
Bitches be like, what club you be at?
That was crazy, bro.
What'd he do?
Paid her rent, nigga.
She was talking in the crowd and she was being too loud and the comedian was basically telling her to be quiet. So the comedian was like, basically, be quiet unless you want to come up here and tell a joke. And then she was like, I'll go up there and tell a joke. And then Mayweather was in the crowd. He said, if you go on stage, I pay your rent. And then everybody was like, ooh. So she walked on stage and didn't even tell a joke. She just walked on stage. It's like, see, I'm on stage. Pay my rent. He was like, how much is it? And she said, $1,500. And nigga whipped out $1,500 and gave it to her.
Oh, she lowballed
her. Lowballed the fuck. Yeah. This is L.A. rent.
Yeah.
Niggas was in the crowd hot.
But you know that $1,500 your go-to number for just hella fast? Nigga like, nigga. I would have said $1,500 too on some fast shit. Like, nigga, I went on stage. Nigga, give me $1,500.
I'd have thought about the highest rent I'd have seen in my community, nigga.
You not going to think somebody going to give you no 9 bands, though, for playing. Maybe. She was playing. Nobody in that motherfucking place thought he was going to pay her rent, bro.
Yeah. That's beautiful. Shout out to Mayweather.
Nigga, I would have just told that nigga saw $1,500 to nigga. Give me $1,500.
For real, I'm taking advantage.
Nigga, $1,500. Now, once you get your $1,500, now that's that. Nigga, I should have said $10,000. Nigga.
I done spent $1,500 in Mayweather fights in my lifetime, nigga. I done bought every pay-per-view, nigga.
Mayweather damn near owe us everybody $1,500, nigga.
Oh, mamas, huh?
Yeah, it ain't no such thing as a halfway crook, man. You know, you feel me? If you rob a bank, whether it's $30 or $30,000, you're getting the same time.
What's the most money you ever asked somebody for?
Oh, man, that's a great question.
Because niggas be standing on that $1,500.
No, somebody gave me $10,000.
You asked for it, though?
Yeah.
That's cool. Yeah.
But in my defense, I did $40,000 worth of shit for them. Uh-huh. And didn't ask for nothing. And then when I needed it, I was like, man, I need $10,000. Mm-hmm. And they broke the bread.
Yeah.
That makes sense. But still, you still asked for $10,000.
Yeah.
Yeah. What's the most money you ever asked for at one time?
Like an individual or?
Individual.
Like a gig.
Nah, not no business shit. We talking about, like, I ain't gonna lie, nigga. You know, you can call a nigga for $1,500.
Bro, I ain't gonna hold you. I be scared to owe niggas money. I always, if I ever have to ask a nigga for something, it's always, I always ask for a low number, nigga. Like, it ain't.
What's the most money you ask for?
Realistically, nigga, like $750.
That's a good amount.
$750.
Oh, $750? Yeah. I don't think you're talking about $7,500.
No.
That ain't bad at all.
Yeah, you a $1 million nigga too, so.
Yeah, you could ask some more, nigga. You talking about the bitch with the $1,500, nigga, you ask for $750.
I be trying, I hate owing niggas anything.
It don't gotta be a nigga, it can be a woman.
Or whatever, nigga. I hate owing anybody.
I feel you, I don't like owing motherfuckers. But when was that like you borrowing it? Cause when somebody give you something, they give it to me.
No, it wasn't borrowed, it was nigga.
Yeah, I'm talking about.
Oh, just give me?
Yeah.
Oh.
Nigga Teddy better be like $300. Yeah.
Nah. Probably a band.
You're a real hood nigga. Yeah. That nigga said a band.
But it's on some, I probably could ask for more. Like,
that's what I'm telling you.
You said yeah, so quick to the band.
That band, $1,500 be the wrong.
I'm gonna tell you, when niggas got it, I'm gonna tell you this is when niggas got it, you better off hitting them with. To get more money, just telling them what you trying to do. So it ain't like sometimes niggas got the bad habit when they got homies that got real money. They want, man, I'm in a bad spot. I need to pay this or pay that. Mm-hmm. But if you more like, man, I'm trying to start this business or I got this situation and I'm trying to solidify it. Mm-hmm. This is why I need this. You can get way more money. But a lot of times people come to people when they in dire straits or dire needs. So they don't like you got to make yourself an investment.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
You feel what I'm saying?
Exactly. I know exactly.
You got, because you, if you got,
that's homies, how you get money out of women and shit.
Yeah, straight up.
Like, best of me to see the best of me.
Man, I'm trying to start this podcast studio. I just need $15,000. But if you feel what I'm saying, that's how you do that type of stuff, man. And people, and if somebody fuck with you, they gonna break bread.
Oh, my mama, because beliefs, you know, somebody really believe you though. The money really ain't shit. That's the least people can do, really.
Right.
Cause they ain't gotta really put in the work.
That's real spill.
Low key, but I didn't have. Now that I'm thinking about this, bro, I didn't ask. I guess I didn't ask for thousands of shit. Now, like,
I break it down in increments. Uh-huh. You break your shit down like a band each type shit. Huh?
I get 2 bands from you, 3 from you. Nah, yeah, kind of. 4 from you.
What is this podcast turning into?
How to borrow money.
This is good advice though, nigga.
It's real spill.
They don't give a fuck who you is, nigga. Everybody need to borrow some money at some point in their life, nigga. I don't give a fuck who you is, nigga. Nobody bigger than borrowing money, nigga. But Donald, I don't like borrowing money. Give me some money.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't like Teddy. I don't like owing nobody. I don't want to owe nobody, nigga. Once you give me something, leave it at that.
It real spill.
And when I can give you something, I'm gonna give it to you. All this borrowing shit.
But that's why I like making, you know, I like making what I make, because I don't feel comfortable telling a nigga, hey, whatever, nigga.
The weird thing, you remember when you was super broke? You ever been around a nigga when you super broke? And he'd spend $30,000 on a bitch, like at the strip club or popping bottles, but you got $50. And you're like, nigga, I was just with you. You spent... I just, You want to? Can I hold 15? You know what I mean?
You want to know something from a motherfucker that don't smoke? What bothered me is when motherfuckers ain't got no cheese and they really smoke a lot.
Yeah.
If you don't got no cheese, bro, slow down on that smoking shit, bro.
Right.
Because yeah. I really been around. But
being broke make you smoke more.
Ben, speak up. Yeah. Hold on, let me speak up.
You don't broke did something to my spirit.
Being broke make you smoke more.
You don't feel poverty.
But you be rolling like thinner blunts though. It's on some like it's reverse psychology.
But niggas be busting down backwoods and shit. Like you smoking on a budget.
A broke nigga bust down a whole backwood. I've seen it.
That's what I'm saying. Why you buying woods and shit, nigga? I should see it in your budget. You should be smoking Swishers or something when you down and out. When you up, nigga smoking backwoods. I see niggas be broke. I've been with niggas full, really broke, but nigga go bust down they last on some weed in the wood. And it's like,
cause nigga, if I die in an hour, nigga, like this, I kinda, you know, what else?
Damn,
niggas only live for like literally right now.
That's real shit.
Damn,
I'm telling nigga, like you, the more I be looking at hood trauma and my personal trauma and why I do shit, how I do shit, like you nigga, like it's cause niggas don't expect to live past nothing.
That's real shit.
I see what you saying though. That's making a lot of sense.
That's why I'ma cheat on the bitch every time, nigga. I'ma do this every time cause I don't picture myself 60 years down the aisle holding hands on a beach with you.
Yeah,
bitch.
That's
niggas is shooting niggas at my age every day.
That's some deep shit. That go back to be you mindful that you a black man and you a nigga.
But, you know, who am I? I'm not Kevin Samuels. I'm just a nigga. You feel me?
The worst is to be the driver and everybody else smoke and you got to keep making these motherfucking liquor store stops to buy blunts. That ain't nothing worse than stopping to buy blunts if you don't smoke.
Oh, yeah.
And that's why I don't stop. Nigga, y'all niggas with me. Nigga, I ain't stopping. Nigga.
I got a trick, Lou. I'm like, Lou, you want some juice or something? Stop it, son.
Stop right here. I got to get some condoms.
Nigga, no, I fuck with Eminem. You want some Eminem? Stop with some Eminem. This nigga come back with some woods and some water. And some
how y'all niggas meet?
I met this nigga at the comedy store.
Comedy store. Yeah, that's why I met everybody out here, damn near.
Yeah,
that was the only place I was accepted at. Shout out to the legend Bob Sumner, man. Shout out Red Grant, man. And Red Grant
used to hold down that Red thing.
Grant. That was the only niggas that let me perform out here in LA.
For real,
nigga. Red Grant and Bob Sumner, nigga. Them niggas the only nigga that believed in me when I first got out here.
Damn,
on some comedian shit.
Bob showed me some love.
Mm-hmm. Bob Sumner, you know I started all of this.
Yeah.
Def Jam Russell used to be in my office while I'm doing what I'm doing.
Yeah, nigga.
Man, shout out Bob Sumner, man. We love
Bob
you, brother.
Bob Sumner for sure. That's the OG.
Last time I seen Bob Sumner, he was at a pizzeria on Cahuenga. And we was in there chilling with some comics, and he just came in there and talked to us about an hour just on the comedy game. Bill Bellamy used to be with me. He was my host at the Peppermint Lounge.
Hilarious.
Every week, you know, you had to be funny. I got a bad Sumner impression, but that's what I
remember. It's on point.
That's what I remember for Bob.
Nah, Bob for sure.
Bobby.
I think I didn't know a lot of people through that night for sure out here.
That was that Tuesday, right?
Yeah, that was Tuesdays for sure.
When Jeru was hosting, that was the night that low-key got my... I had to audition to be on ADD.
Oh, wow. Really?
Like, and it was in front of Russell people or whatever.
Uh-huh.
Russell didn't show up. I thought he would. That nigga didn't come.
Damn.
And then it was his people there, and...
That shit worked.
It worked. You know.
Damn, that's crazy.
That's why I be like, everybody got on ADD different ways, nigga. It ain't like, no.
Yeah,
niggas be entitled, like, whatever. Uh-huh. I'm like, nigga, I should be entitled, nigga. I had to audition.
Damn.
I had to audition, too, after you plugged me.
Oh, yeah, you
did. Yeah, go up to the office in Culver City.
That nigga Bob Sumner brought me to Jeru.
For real?
He was like, this is the guy. He was like, you know, I know. It was funny. This was before Carlos Miller blew up, too. He was like, I'm telling you. Carlos Miller, Lewis Belt. I'm telling you. He's it right here. He brought me introduced. That's how I met Giroux, because I met him through Bob.
Oh, that's dope.
Yeah, so I'm like, I didn't know who. I just knew Giroux was important because I'm like, Bob talked to this nigga. So I'm like, shit. I was on some young shit. I was mobbing, nigga. I was mobbing. I didn't know shit about Hollywood. I was mobbing. I ain't gonna lie. I'm so way better.
Yeah,
I'm like,
yeah, we wasn't like kicking it when I first saw you. Mm-hmm. I can only imagine. I remember you being like, yeah, nigga, I just drove from the Bay. And you made it seem like you just drove down here every time from the Bay.
I was doing it every 2 weeks.
I was like, what the fuck? Like, hell no.
Nigga, and I'm fresh, nigga. As soon as you see me, nigga, I'm really straight from the Bay. Nigga, just got out here, nigga, like an hour ago type shit. So, nigga, I'm not adapted to no industry. Yeah. I don't come from that. It ain't no fucking, it wasn't no industry in the Bay. So it's like, nigga, I'm coming out here. What niggas on? I'm talking like that. What niggas on? Where's yanking at, nigga? Like, you feel me? I'm trying to
perform.
Where's
yanking at?
Like, nigga, I'm walking up to, nigga, Jeru's and all that. Man, like, how I'm be able to perform on this shit? Like, this is how I'm talking to niggas. Not, like, ignorant, but it's just, like...
Did they ever tell you about, like, lingo? Like, you talk with too much lingo?
No, I just noticed it within time because motherfuckers would be just laughing at it, like... Because I really... That's normal. Nobody tripped off it in the Bay, but shit. Yeah. Out here, when I got out here, motherfuckers laughing, nigga. I'm trying to get on stage. Fuck you laughing at my ism for, nigga. Nigga, oh, he rhyming. And fuck, it's funny, nigga. I'm trying to perform. Niggas, oh man. Nigga, what? What's going on? I was on some other shit. I was in a beating nigga ass, all type of shit, all that shit.
Tell niggas come be thinking niggas is characters. I'll be like,
nigga, what?
As
nigga
much as a nigga weird. Is a character, I always know niggas are real, is like you say, is nigga man first.
Yeah.
And a lot of people don't think like that.
They don't think like that.
They be, I didn't say niggas disrespect nigga told Cat me to Williams shh like,
at the Comedy Store.
Ooh.
I don't know. I just remember. But knowing me, the old me now, I probably was hella loud. Yeah. I was hella loud, I guess.
You
in the
was.
Backstage. I probably was hella loud at the you Comedy was. Store talking in the backstage. Somebody, all I heard was somebody whip the curtain back and say, shh. So who the fuck you talking to, nigga? Nigga ain't never said nothing. I don't know who this person is. They left me the fuck alone. That was at the Comedy Store. Then I went to the Wednesday night. Nigga called me weird. I said, let me holler at you, bro.
Ooh-wee.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you can't call a nigga
all type weird. Of shit. So I'm like, I'm tripping. I used to walk in, people like, what's wrong with you? Like, nigga, I just walked in. I guess because I wasn't networking. I was walking. Right. I was going to where it's at, but I wasn't networking.
Yeah.
So I'm not going, hey, my name is Lewis. I'm from the Bay Area. What's your name?
Right.
I'm not talking to
you.
You
my man, like, nigga should know you.
Yeah, because, nigga, I'm the nigga where I'm from.
Yeah.
And this L.A., I know y'all know about the shit, but it wasn't no Bay L.A. shit. It was right,
because
right.
I knew the
comedy
internet,
shit.
I was like, I follow this nigga, so I was like, I get it. I had to seize this nigga. He really don't think I met Sonny Bo first, but I really met Sonny Bo first, nigga. Like, and then I was like, "What the fuck is this nigga doing? This nigga on stage with the braids, like acting like he finna rob the crowd and all kind of shit, nigga." I was like, "What the fuck is this?"
Having fun.
And then you know he snapped out of character. I was like, "All right, met the nigga. Okay, that's what's up. Nice to meet you. Woo woo woo." You know, and then I'm in the following shit, so
yeah.
And we follow this nigga, and I'm like, oh, okay, he's acting like the typical, Bay. Or what, you know, Bay, he's just acting like the typical Bay nigga, you
right.
Feel me, like, but amplified, though, yeah. You know?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that shit legendary, man.
So I'm like, damn, I had to really readjust the shit, so I get it, but I had to learn, like, yeah. Damn. But
I thought you was gonna wear that wig every day.
Damn, really?
Yeah.
Wow. And I bet hella people probably thought that.
Oh.
That's crazy. Yeah. But I wouldn't say that because back home they understood it. That's what made me, that's what LA helped me because it made me, I was in a whole area where people didn't know what the shit was.
Right.
It's just like,
but
what's Sonny
doing? The thing about art always helps people see the reflection of what is.
Right, or
whatever was at that time, you know, niggas was naked back in the Greek days with little dicks, nigga. That's why all the statues is Greek niggas with little dicks, nigga. You they was perverts and shit, and right. Had kids chiseling them all day. I don't know.
Yeah,
I don't know what them niggas' lives was, but you know, The Art of the 80s, nigga, Too Short. Start rapping about dope and pimping. Nigga, that was Oakland at that time, nigga.
Yeah, yeah.
Yo, comedic art, nigga, is Oakland of today. Yeah. Or the Bay of today, you know? Yeah. So, it's needed.
Yeah. Yeah, it just took time for people to understand the Sonny Bus shit. It was like, you trying to be like Old Dog? Nigga, Old Dog, y'all niggas lost in the sauce. I was looking back at it, yeah, it makes sense now, for sure.
Niggas don't never understand the dope shit at first.
This felt like the longest episode ever.
I forgot we was recording. How long is this shit?
2 hours.
You lying.
Cut the tape.
It's
1 hour 54 minutes? Oh, yeah, this shit old. Y'all should be hella long.
I'm like, nigga, dude, I done rolled about 4 blunts.
Damn, your episodes be 2.5 hours?
I just did 2:54 before I came here.
So that's why
this nigga.
Damn. Probably liked it. They be probably asking for a longer episode.
Yeah, they want this shit. Fuck with this.
He the nigga that come in the gym and put all the plates on the way.
Oh, yeah, that's me, yeah.
Nigga, I got all the 45s on there. Nigga.
But I be really digging in the ideas and shit. I be really finding different ways to think about shit, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's what I use my shit for. Just abstract thought and roasting niggas.
You sound like a killer that love to kill. you know, you ever talk to a nigga that just like buying hella straps and shit? Like, I got this one because you know this one. It's like, damn, you really love guns and shit.
This nigga always cleaning
this the nigga like a roast fanatic. I do this shit just to think of ways I could just roast the nigga.
Nigga, the Dexter of roasting.
That's hilarious.
I love the game. I love the roast. Just do something to me.
Yo, yes, it's a universal language, nigga.
Your mama and shit.
Yeah. Well, shit. It's the Cali Kickback.
You got anything you want to say to the people?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Check out my show Mondays on Caffeine.
Yeah.
From 6 to 8. This week I got Geechee Gotti and Hit Boy. 6 to 8 on Caffeine. And then Tuesdays and Thursdays on my own platform.
The Hit Craig Boy been going crazy, man.
That's my nigga.
Shout out to Hit Boy, man. You welcome over here too at the Cali Kickback, brother.
And man, every day you can catch me streaming all over the world. Apple Music, Spotify, all that shit. Just type in Kraig Facts. 250 episodes in.
Damn.
That part.
Then you can catch me on the radio. 1580 AM Talk Radio. You know what I'm saying?
That part.
This nigga,
who was it owned by? Talk your shit. It's
owned by Tavis Smiley.
Yeah, nigga.
Then you can catch my Patreon, watch my little sitcom, Big Head Kraig. Then you can purchase the Chill Withers album. That's got 10 million streams on it. You know what I'm saying? I'm about to release another album called The Chill Never Withers. You know what I'm saying? I got niggas on there, bro, far as producers. Fuck with me, man. I'm the nigga you need to know that you didn't realize you needed to know who he was. Right.
Pop your piece.
You know what I'm saying?
That part.
And find me on a nigga on a bitch's head, on a nigga's head, on a dog's head, on my own head. I'm just own heads. Pause. With this laughter and this stand up. And if I owe you something, get it from God, nigga. God.
You know what I'm saying? If you know us, you owe us, man. You understand me? It's the Cali Kickback. Kraig Facts in this motherfucking man.
Teddy Ray, you already know what
Teddy
it is.
Teddy Ray, I'm talking about.
Cali Kickback. Ooh.
Thank y'all. I love everybody.
You need an air tracker to get your bitch back.